birthday on Monday, right? So I'll invite a few people and we'll have a surprise do at the Rovers.
Well, not too much of a surprise, eh?
No, it'll be okay. I'll see you later.
See ya.
Hey, Kev. Guess what he did last night?
What?
He turned himself over. So he goes from lying on his tummy to lying on his back. With just a little bit of help, but not much.
Another visitor. It's non-stop. Everyone wants to see the baby.
Yeah.
Hi, Pam.
Oh, hiya, love.
Hi, Mal.
So we're arranging this christening. We go to see the vicar, right? And he says, "Are you both practicing Christians?" And Molly says, "No," and he's looking straight at me. So just says, "Yeah, of course we are." And then it says, "And the baby, he definitely is."
Well, I've only one question to ask, and you know what that is.
And the answer's yes. Kevin is still going to be the godfather, and why? Because I can't think of a way of stopping him.
You could have stopped him by not asking him in the first place.
That wasn't me, it was Tyrone.
Poor Tyrone.
No, he's not poor Tyrone. He's the happiest he's ever been in his life.
Only because he don't know just how unhappy he should be.
Oh, for goodness sake, is this what you've come round for? To remind me that I once made the biggest mistake of my life? Well, thank you, but I don't need reminding. I've got a permanent reminder right here. Which I'm not saying that I'm sorry about. It's just, I'm not likely to forget, am I?
Of course you're not, no, love. Hey. And I'm here to help you and support you. And always will be, whatever happens.
Nothing's going to happen. But he actually said that?
He doesn't want Terry at his funeral.
Why?
He says he doesn't think of him as a son anymore. He just wants people there that he loves.
I suppose.
Anyway, don't say that.
Hey, Kev, come and have a look. Just had a great big smile on his face.
Which is gone now, so will we. Oh, we'll be getting in your way. I'll see you later.
Yeah, okay. Bye. Bye, little Jack. Look after your mum till I get home. Well, you know, can't imagine what life was like without him. It was just the two of us in that house. What did we do all day?
I don't know.
Well, I won't want to go back to it.
How's it going?
Oh, been another half hour or so. Happen a bit more.
Okay, I'm just going to pop on for 10 minutes. See to something.
Yeah, sure.
Girls, I've just been on the phone to my manager.
Oh, my manager.
Well, he is my manager. What else would you call him?
Unlock it.
Right, anyway, he wants me to do this job tomorrow. It's in the country, but I told him I don't know because it's my little sister's 16th birthday. So we're having a big party, aren't we?
No. A little party.
With a couple of friends, two or three, nothing fancy.
Oh, right. Okay, I'll tell him I could do this job tomorrow. Could you rest?
You don't want a big party, do you?
Not really.
What, and have everyone watching us, see what we get up to when we've had a drink? No, thank you.
Jack's not in, is he?
Well, no, but he could be back any minute.
Right, I'll try and make it quick. I've tried. I really have tried. Telling myself, your baby's nothing to do with me. Tyrone's the dad and I'm just going to stay out of it.
So what are you doing here?
Well, it's not that simple, is it? When Ty talks about nothing else, all day it's what baby Jack's been up to. Oh, you should see him, Kev.
Because he loves him.
Yeah, I'm not denying that. All I'm saying is it doesn't make my life any easier. And then I see you out pushing him in his pram and hear other folk talking about him. It's all anyone seems to talk about, at least when I'm around.
So what am I supposed to do? Tell them to stop?
No, what I want you to do, I want you to agree to us doing a DNA test. Look, you've always said yourself you're not sure who the father is.
Yes, I am. It's Tyrone.
No, you don't know who the biological father is.
None of that matters.
Yeah, it matters to me. I've tried not to let it, but it's there, nagging at me all the time. Am I the child's father or not? I've tried telling myself, well, I'll never know. But it's no good. I have to.
Well, I don't. So too bad.
You can't just say that.
Yeah, I can. There is not going to be a DNA test.
I don't need it, no.
I will know. It's not going to happen.
You'll still expect me there at the christening?
I'd a lot rather you weren't. Make an excuse, say you're poorly. I'd be delighted.
Yeah, well, I can't do that.
Well, I can't agree to a DNA test. Not now, not ever. So there we are.
I can't believe that.
What, you thought we was
The two most popular girls in college. The ones everybody wanted to be with.
We're the two people most definitely don't want to be with.
Yeah, or they'll get called the same names as we do.
Like what?
Well, you know, also, just like lesbian. But like, oh, stay away from them too.
Because you never know who they might fancy next.
Well, is this why you don't want a big party?
Yeah.
Well, it's one of the reasons.
Well, don't you worry about them. Who are they anyway? About half of them don't even wear bras.
Right.
I've got to go. But you know what you have? What they haven't? It's a big sister that's on your side. Right, that'll be Jason for me.
Jason?
Yeah. We're going out, did you not know?
Why would we know?
Well, it's no secret. And I...
Rosie and Jason.
Won't we worry about what people say about us?
Do you think you should have a middle name? It's just that Jack Dobbs sounds a bit...
honest and decent, like someone who, if you'd lost your purse and he found it, you know you'd get it back with every penny in it.
No, I don't need one.
Who does?
I'm gonna be so proud, you know, stood there next to you, holding our son. Or you holding him. Or Kev holding him, I don't know, maybe it's the godfather.
Well, someone will be holding him, won't they? Not just gonna be lay there on the floor.
Do I have to do a speech or anything?
No.
Kev might do that, might he?
I don't know why you're speaking to me like I'm some sort of expert on christenings. How many do you think I've been to?
I don't know.
Well, none, apart from my own, which I can't remember, so we just shut up about it. You're making me nervous.
No, I don't mean to do that. And there's nothing to worry about. It'd be fantastic. It'd be the best christening ever.
Can't be doing this today, Sal. I'm up to my neck.
Oh, stop complaining.
Well, I'm only staying for one drink afterwards.
You leave when I leave and that's final. Now sign that card for little baby Jack. There you go, love.
Thank you.
It's not very imaginative.
Mum? You shouldn't give me this, Mum.
Oh, well, buy yourself something nice.
Oh, them boots. From way ahead of you.
A sensible wintered coat wouldn't hurt.
Oh, yeah, and how about a matching hat and scarf to go with? News/judge, your little girl is 16. Sensible has left the building.
Oh, I think it's cute. Mm.
It's underwear.
Oh, you're kidding, right?
Oh, don't be such a prude anyway, underwear. It's always essential.
Yeah, especially when it's sexy underwear.
Right, it was a free sample, but it didn't fit. It was a bit too small.
Only a present from you could also qualify as a put-down.
Excuse me, check the label.
Oh, thank you, sis. This is just me left then.
Okay, now that is gorgeous.
Oh, Sham, that's beautiful.
It must have cost you a fortune. What was she thinking of?
You. Oh.
Jack didn't eat much.
Oh, well, he's just excited. Isn't he, mate, eh? It's a big day. Right, this christening lark. First up, there's water involved. You're getting wet, mate. Sorry, comes with the territory.
Hey, but it's not all bad, because you also get godparents today. Yeah, you do. Kevin and Sally.
What's a godparent? Very good question. Well, imagine life is a car, right? I mean, in our case, it's just a Ford, but it could be a Subaru Impreza or an Audi TT, or, and this is my dream motor, a Lancia Integrale. Left-hand drive only, but a tool nonetheless. Where was I?
I have no idea.
Oh, yeah, a car, right? So a car has got two kinds of brakes, hasn't it, yeah? A handbrake and a foot brake.
When they're working.
Your mum and me. We're the foot brake. I mean, our job is just to keep you safe and, you know, basically keep you going along at the right pace. And godparents is a handbrake. They're there to provide extra backup. And when it comes to providing extra backup, kiddo, you couldn't ask for any better than Kevin Webster. Could you?
Isn't it funny how things work out?
What are you on about?
Well, Molly and I. I mean, it wasn't long ago that we're hardly on speaking terms and now look at us.
It's terrific.
I'm telling you now, we're embracing this. That child will want for nothing, not on this side of the street. Whatever Jack needs, we'll always be there for him.
Haven't you gone yet?
Oh, just look at the time. Shake a leg, Kevin.
She's useless.
Oh, look at her. Do you know, it wasn't long ago she couldn't do up her own shoelaces, and now she's doing her dad's tie.
Mum?
She's not your little baby anymore, Kev.
I am, Dad. Of course I am.
and I'll be a little baby forever.
Oh, I so wish my dad could see this.
What?
That's why you're going to be a wonderful godfather.
Hey.
And personally, I think that godparents are just like good caddies. Now, in a golf course, you have...
Dad, get up! Hiya! Oh, can I have a hold? Oh, aren't you just so delicious? Oh, looks and his cheeks could just eat him.
Oh, I know.
Chillax,
yeah?
They'll be here.
Like Kevin, it's
Jack's
Christmas.
This is a sham. I know, love, but we just got to get through the day. Here.
See you now.
Claire not able to make it, then?
Try to convince her, but she's not having it. Falling apart, Jack.
Oh, come on, don't talk like that. You can sort it.
I wish you had your faith, mate.
Well, this is the place to find it, son.
All right, lads.
Kev.
Oh, Tyrone, if we're late, blame Kevin.
Oh, no, you're all right. There's loads of time, yeah? We're going to...
You caught it fine. Making a point, are we?
We go.
Today isn't about you and me.
Look, I don't know what goes on in that of yours. I got delayed at work, OK? There's no hidden agenda.
Right, I think we're ready to start. Everything all right?
ML was just reminding me not to drop the baby.
Well, there you go then, mate.
Take him, Kevin. He won't bite.
There you go.
Feel free to take pictures or video. Now, would Molly and Tyrone and the godparents please come forward?
This'll be us soon.
Faith is the gift of God to his people. In baptism, the Lord is adding to our number those whom he is calling. People of God, will you welcome Jack and uphold him in his new life in Christ?
With the help of God, we will.
Parents and godparents, the church receives Jack with joy. Today we are trusting God for his growth in faith. Will you pray for him, draw him by your example into the community of faith, and walk with him in the way of Christ?
With the help of God, we will.
In baptism, Jack begins his journey in faith. You speak for him today. Will you care for him and help him to take his place within the life and worship of Christ Church?
With the help of God, we will.
In baptism, God calls us out of darkness into his marvellous light. To follow Christ means dying to sin and rising to new life with him. Therefore I ask, do you reject the devil and all rebellion against God?
We reject them.
Do you renounce the deceit and corruption of evil?
We renounce them.
I am having. I'm just come to terms with something. I've got a grim show to do.
Jason's all right.
Sure he is. However, as a mother, you'll soon learn that all right is never quite good enough.
Hey, come on, let's get a picky of the two Jacks.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
Tight, love, be a love
scooped
out at roll. Come on.
Oh.
Right, are we ready?
Yeah.
Say cheese.
Cheese.
Oh, that's gorgeous.
One for the wallet, Jack? No, this one I'll be
carrying
in my heart, Bill.
Hiya.
Hiya.
Sorry, I can't wait
to Christmas. Oh, it's all right, Molly and me understand.
So what's the problem?
Well, there isn't one.
But your text said...
I asked him to send it.
I'll leave you guys to it.
Ask me to tell me you split up.
Did he know?
Mm-hmm. Can't tell you how sorry I am.
Not as sorry as I am.
Like to help if I can.
Somehow I think we're a bit beyond that.
The lad knows he's messed up.
He has no right involving you, Jack.
Yeah, but he has. Can he not do an old man a favour and only speak to him? Go on, find a reason for him, that bottle.
No promises.
Drinks are on me, Sean.
And a double whiskey.
Well, at least pretend you're having a good time.
Aye. Anybody would think you didn't want to be here.
I think I'll get myself another pint.
Yeah, I think I'll join you. Pull yourself together. If you can't play at being a godfather, at least try acting like a man.
There you go, Kev. Have that one.
Oh, cheers.
And here's to you. This won't mean anything without you and Sal.
So we're just going to sit here in silence.
What do you expect me to say?
Claire, I just want to talk.
So you get Jack to Shanghai me?
He was only trying to help. Anyway, it's not like you're giving us an option. Look, I can't keep saying I'm sorry. What I did
was sick and cruel.
I was desperate. I wasn't thinking straight.
Oh, now you are.
There must be some way forward.
I'll find it.
So now we're back to square one.
You really don't get it, do you? Ashley, you are not a part of this anymore. I'm moving to France with the boys, whether you like it or not.
It's not happening.
Oh, try stopping me. Because what's inside my heart at this minute, let's just say it's not angina.
What do you think you're playing at?
Oh, not the time and the place.
Oh, and the church was. You couldn't have made it more obvious if you'd have worn a sandwich board.
Have you any idea how hard that was for me?
We're not having this conversation again.
Put it to bed. Take a DNA test. What harm can it do?
I said no, and I meant no.
Burying your head in the sand might work for you, but I can't live that way. Please, I'm begging you.
What? Like you begged me to have an abortion?
What all this is about. Payback.
No! No, Kevin, it's about choice. You chose not to be Jack's father when you walked away. Now, I'm choosing to believe that Tyrone is. It's as simple as that.
This is...
Oh, well, thank you for coming. Oh,
thanks for inviting me.
Proper do this. You guys.
Give it a rest, Kirk.
Fair play.
Right, now, you want any help with the presents?
No, I think we'll cope, thank you. Right. Mwah. Ty, people are leaving.
Just pop to the loo and then I think we should be leaving as well.
Samples off this morning for some DNA testing. I forgot to ask, how long does it take to get the results back? Yeah, Kevin Webster. Really? By the end of the day, that's brilliant. No, if I pay, could you send them by courier? Yeah, it's Webster's Auto Centre, Coronation Street, Weatherfield, M10 9KC. All right, cheers, thank you, bye.
There's all ammo!
Nothing.
Couriers, eh? Sounds a bit mysterious. Not a secret agent, are you?
No, it's that check I've been chasing up, you know, from that Gilbertson fella.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I told him I want it today, so he's sending it across.
Well, you do right, mate, yeah? His mess is about long enough, aren't they? Although you should have made him pay for it himself.
Yeah, well, if it means we get it.
Suppose.
You didn't do it just because of me, did you?
What?
For Christmas.
No, of course we didn't. I know neither of us are very religious, but it makes it sort of special somehow, doesn't it, having a naming ceremony?
It does. And I am glad I were there for it.
And so are we.
You know, you look as if you've been doing that all your life.
Well, I've had a lot of practice, Anna, looking after Tyrone.
Aye. You're as good a wife as you are a mother.
Don't be daft.
No, I mean, it's a blessing to me. knowing that it's going to be left in safe hands.
Have you seen that blue dummy?
What's happened?
The oven's just gone off.
Oh no, it must be a power cut.
Oh, the flipping food!
Never mind that, what about my hair?
Go and try in the light.
I'm gonna have to go and get my dad.
What's up?
The electricity's gone off.
No, I thought someone had died.
What do you mean, is that all? I've got pies tonight.
Well, I'll do it when I finish work.
No, Dad, there's no time. I'm in the middle of cooking.
It's all right, I can manage it.
Come on.
I'll be back as soon as I can.
Oh, no probs. Blimey. He actually sent it. Right.
All right.
Hey, babe.
Huh? You fixed it yet?
No, and I won't if you keep mouthing.
Woo!
Flaming fuse, you could have done that yourselves.
Yeah, well, how come it took you so long?
You didn't know where it was, did I?
Thanks, Dad.
Me, you what? No.
Now. Maybe you can sell this. Has baby Jack got my eyebrows or Molly's?
What?
Well, she thinks they look like mine and I think they look like hers.
I'm sure Kevin's not bothered.
Did this come with a courier?
Yeah, I started to open it but I got distracted. Is it that chair?
Yes! And you just left it lying on the car roof. Anyone could have taken this.
Sorry?
Yeah, well, think on next time. And you shouldn't bring him round here either. It's not safe.
All right, well, we're just going.
See ya. Well, sorry, mate, I should have thought.
It's okay.
Could you give us a hand with this exhaust? It's stuck on solid.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, all right, so what time do you think you'll get here? Right, okay, babe, but just please don't forget the vodka. All right, bye. All right, next time. Bye-bye.
Hey, turn it down. Got some nice cakes and things.
Ah, thanks, Mum.
This party isn't going to be wild, is it?
No. Just, I don't know, Chesney and Kate and some of the choir girls.
Mum, I'm surprised they haven't invited Emily. They'll probably be playing Snap by 9 o'clock.
You don't have to be here.
I want her here, just in case.
Yeah, I like how you and Dad bail out to the pub.
Leave me with this lot.
Yeah, well, with any luck, some of it might rub off on you. What, do you want me to turn gays on, Mum?
You know what I mean. It is possible to have fun without getting absolutely legless, you know.
Oh, yeah, well, I should remind you of that, Mum, when you come home drunk.
Right, I'm going to go and get changed.
Yeah, don't worry, Mum, I will.
We'll call it a day, eh?
Yeah, I reckon another half hour should be done.
No, we can finish this tomorrow.
You sure?
Positive, yeah. You get off.
Right, well, not going to argue with you, mate. Sooner I get back to little Jack, the better. I'll just clear up my tools.
No, I'll do that.
Yeah? Well, nice one, cheers. See you tomorrow.
Bye.
Sophie, we go to the pub.
Why?
Well, get out of the way so she can enjoy her birthday party.
Oh, that, right.
And I said we'd meet Gail down there.
Not the party, the pub. I think she needs her friends round her at a time like this.
Times like what?
Kevin, do you not listen to anything I tell you?
Well, I can't remember everything, can I? There's no brain big enough to take in everything you witter on about.
David, he's got to cut a cord. What's got into you?
Oh, just a bad day at the office.
Well, do you think you could clock off early? Your boss let you.
I can have a word with him.
Because actually, I quite fancy your boss.
So?
Oh, there's no need to look scared. It's only a joke. Come on, girl's going to be sat on her own. Tyrone and Kurt, actually. Go and talk to them.
That's what we used to.
So anyway, isn't it Sophie's party tonight?
Yeah.
You're very brave,
I'm worried you said that.
Hope you left your valuables out.
We haven't got any valuables.
Carpets, left them down.
Yes.
People can be very light-fingered, Sally.
Oh, I don't think a gang of 16-year-old born-again Christians are going to go nicking my tufted shag girl.
Yeah, but they advertise parties now, don't they, on facial internet sites? You never know. Could end up with a house full of 30-year-old dealers selling methalone.
Hey, you all right? Drop a pint, Kev?
No, I'm all right, thanks.
Sal?
Oh, I'll have another white wine, Tyrone, please.
Gail?
Yeah,
sure, Kev.
Positive.
What
do that for?
What?
Who's going to want to sit with us now, innit?
It's your friend, Kevin. Don't be so narky.
I've been working with him all day.
Get over it.
Look, I don't want to be staring at his ugly mug all night long too, do I? I've just had a woman on the phone stuck in Saddlewick with a broken wheel. She wants me to talk her through replacing it. I'll go and find somewhere a bit quieter to phone about. She kept breaking up.
All right, see you later. Oh, Kevin, while you're out, could you pop your head in the party and just check everything's all right?
Of course. See you in a bit.
See
you. Hi, guys!
Everybody, this is my sister, Rosa.
Rose by name, Rose by nature.
Sophie, are those lesbians?
No, Rosa, they're from the choir from church.
Oh, I thought they looked a bit dull.
Well, why don't you have a dance with Sean?
Why don't you keep your voice down?
What are you looking at?
Nothing. It's called a cleavage.
You know all about that, don't you, darling?
Hi, babe.
Yeah? I hope my dad didn't see me coming in.
Happy birthday, Sophie.
Thanks, Kate.
I got you a present. It's just a little thing.
Cool party, Sophie.
Thanks, Chess.
I'll get it!
Whose party is this?
Yours or hers?
It's mine. She's just kind of like my little slave.
Oh, nice one.
Oh, that's too cute.
That's
all right.
Where's my name on that?
Everyone, who's for cherry vodka? Come on. Hi.
I am sexy.
Rosa, who is that?
This is Tom Crew, the local drag king.
Look, she's doing this PA for free because I said there'll be lots of hot chicks here. Yeah, but she's doing it because she's totally crazy about me, aren't you?
Sophie, why is that girl dressed as a blonde?
I think she thinks it's fancy dress or something.
Do you have a problem with me being your party planner?
Do you want your own?
Well, baby Jack's upstairs.
Yeah, what about big Jack?
He's out. Why? What's going on? We've got nothing left to say to each other, Kevin.
That's where you're wrong. I had a DNA test done. I'm his dad. Not tired on me.
How dare you? How dare you go behind my back when I told you not to?
I had to know, Molly.
How did you do it? How did you get his DNA?
The question is, where do we go from here?
You must have taken a swab from him without my consent. That's a violation. You violated my baby.
Our baby.
That's a vile thing to do.
Well, the ends justified the means.
I don't care what you say. My baby will never be yours, ever. Can you go, please?
I'm stopping here until we work out what to do.
use your hands, please, lads and lasses. Are you getting up close and personal?
Sophie, down this now.
Kissing her partner.
I know, no, she's not doing it to turn guys on. They actually look at each other and stuff.
No.
Sophie?
Pasta.
Right.
Come on, Martha, join in the fun.
Loving the drag, babe.
Happy birthday, Sophie.
What's her problem? Come on, guys, let's get this party back for the wild, wild road.
How could you do this to me?
It's not just you who've done it to, is it? It's gonna kill me. Knowing my son's being brought by someone else across the road.
Oh, so what? Are you saying we should get back together?
Don't be soft.
Access? What?
Sally, I'd love that. I just needed to know. I wish I didn't know.
In my head, he was Tyrone's. Now this is going to kill me too, thanks to you.
I know, and I'm sorry. I should be happy. I just couldn't get out of my head.
Oh, what? Like an itch you had to scratch? A scab you just had to pick?
Yeah, something like that.
And now it'll never heal over.
Look, I can't cope.
Every time Tyrone picks him up, I'll feel sick, knowing that that's not his child. It's not Tyrone's. I don't want him to be Kevin, not yours.
I know.
I want him to be Tyrone's.
Is she all right?
Who?
The woman on the phone.
Yeah, sorry.
Why, what's this?
Nothing.
And the party?
Yeah, great.
Did you pop your head in?
Yes, it's all fine.
To bite my head off? The born again Christian cell. The place would be like a library.
I thought you were at Connie's.
Yeah, I come back a while ago. You were sparking out on the couch, so I thought I'd go for a lie down myself.
You just got up?
Aye. You okay?
Yes, I am fine. It's just hormones ignore me.
Aye, you'll be all over the place, won't you?
Oh, I am, yeah. Just, do you want a brew?
Aye, smashing, aye.
Look through the window. Sophie!
Yes, Dad?
Sort this out. This is bang out of order.
She's a drag queen.
Oh, what?
Oh, Mum, get the programme. Fancy a dance off stuff.
I'm a married woman. Chesney, can you stop doing that?
I know, gross.
Oh, very convincing.
I'm going for the walk.
Was that something I said?
Sophie, in the conservatory now, I want to work.
Yes.
I'm not drunk.
You are. Walk in a straight line.
Mum, I'm a lesbian. I don't do anything straight.
When do you wake up in the morning with a crippling hangover? Remember this.
Guess what, like Katie Barber.
You've embarrassed me. You've embarrassed your father. Don't embarrass your sister, because that's impossible. But you have embarrassed yourself.
A tedder. A flaming tedder. How old does she think I am? Six.
Hiya.
Hiya, son.
Hiya, how was your night?
Yeah, brilliant.
Yeah.
Well, it was all right. Kev was a bit off tonight.
Was he?
Oh, I'll do that.
No, you're all right, I'll do it.
No, you've had him all day and night. It's the least I can do. There you go. Hey, Jack. How much do I love my son, eh?
I know you do, lad. Going off to bed.
All right, now night, Jack.
Night, mate.
Good night, son.
It's a surprise, so if you see him, don't let on. Yeah, spread the word, more the merrier. All right, cheers. I'll see you later, Kent. Bye.
Can he come?
Yeah,
there'll be quite a few now.
Oh, he's going to be so chuffed.
Hey, up.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jack.
Happy birthday to you.
You shun now.
Come on, cards. That's off me and Molly.
All right.
And that one's from Baby Jack.
For his granddad. He'd give it himself, but he's still in bed.
I don't know what to say.
Come on then, present.
It was a bit tricky.
Yeah, well, it's pointless buying me a premium bond, isn't it?
Well, just see what you think anyway.
I hope you've not spent a lot of money on this. Some time since I've seen one of them.
I found it in a charity shop with these.
Nancy Archer, Tony Bennett, Matt Munro.
We thought they might bring back memories.
Did we do all right?
You did perfect.
Oh, well, I'm very sorry, Mrs. Carmichael. She's a responsible girl normally. Well, she's in very serious trouble, if that's any consolation. Yeah, well, anyway, I'm sorry that you've had to ring. Bye. I found another mark.
Who was that?
That was a mother of one of the choir girls complaining that this house is a den of iniquity. Rosie, Sophie, Sean, come down here this minute. If you got back here sooner, it would have helped. I still don't understand where you were all that time. I
told you, an emergency call.
Well, you could have looked in afterwards.
Like I said, everything seemed fine.
Yeah, well, just make sure you're at Jack's this dinner time.
We don't have to go there, do we?
Yes, you do. I promise Molly now. You can make the effort for once. There you are. Do you know, that was Rona Carmichael's mother on the phone. She spent all Friday night being sick. She doesn't want to see another water pistol again as long as she lives. I wouldn't mind, but you're not even old enough to drink.
Yeah, well, I've told her it's Rose's doing.
And I found another stain here, look.
Yeah, we'll clean it all up.
I don't know what you were thinking.
Do I hear Michelle likes burning?
Well, I don't see why I am getting the blame for all this.
Yeah, well, I didn't see you in a rush to get everyone out.
Maybe because I was too drunk to think straight.
That's because you're enjoying yourself a while.
Yeah, well, just get it cleaned up today, OK? All three of you.
Yeah, and don't let it happen again.
Will you stop worrying about the pastor?
No one died, did they?
No. And the rest of the choir seemed all right for us being together.
Shani was paralytic.
I know that, but
only if the pasta would have been.
So, hiya. Right, look, I'm sorry things went out of control the other night, but did you or did you not have the best part of your life? See?
Yeah.
Now we're in trouble.
Oh, chill out. Give it a couple of weeks and they'll have forgotten.
I'm not worried about Mum and Dad.
Well, who? The pasta. You're seeing us snogging.
What, that bigger bloke?
Probably the best thrill he's had in years.
It's not funny.
Well, what did he say?
Nothing. He just left a present. And when? We've got a prayer meeting with him today.
Yeah, well, now you've got nothing to hide.
I just be up front with him. That's what I do. Isn't that what it's all about? Gay pride and all that?
Rosa, it's not as simple as that in church.
Oh, well, give up the church and start living and stop blaming me.
Yeah.
I know I'd go from rags to riches if you would only say you care. And though my pocket may be empty,
Wanna go for a drink? Sorry.
No, you're all right, lad. Just doing a bit of reminiscing. One of Alvira's favourites, that. Always brought a tear to her eye.
Don't do that for me.
No. Just a lad to listen to music. What was it you wanted?
Just wanted to see if you wanted to go to Rovers.
Grand, right. Come and sit with me a while.
Are you okay?
Just a bit thoughtful, that's all. Can I ask you a question?
Yeah, fire away.
You happy?
Never been happier. Apart from what's happening to you. I've got a wife that I love and a son that I adore.
So things are okay with you and Molly then?
You know, we had that rocky patch, but that's all sorted now.
Because it means a lot to me going to my grave, knowing that you two are happy.
Yeah, well, you've got no worries on that score.
Good.
Are you sure that's all this is about?
Oh, no, there's nothing else. No, there's putting an old man's mind at rest. Come here. Hey, you're a good lad. I'd swap you any time for our Terry. Right, come on. Let's go and do a bit of living.
Aye.
You know, there's nothing nice than having a quiet party on your birthday.
Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, Jack.
It's your day.
No.
I'm your foot for cards.
Surprise! Fine, was it, Jack?
Well, go on, I'll force one down.
There you go, lads.
Jack! Happy birthday, Jack.
Oh, thank you, Emily. I'm running now, please. Help me.
There you go, Jack. Many happy returns.
Thank you, my friend.
And this is off me and Sally. Glad we could be here.
Aye.
And this is from me, you miserable beggar.
Oh, he's loving every minute of it.
My imagination was Jack a bit off with you then.
Was it?
Happy birthday.
Well, you must have made a killing on these birthday cards this morning, Peter.
I put my prices up as soon as I knew what were happening.
Well, it didn't joke, but you know, Alfie really would have done that.
God rest his memory.
I was just thinking, Jack, are you 72? 73?
Oh, but don't embarrass him.
No, I've got no to hide, Emily. I'm 74.
A youngster.
I was born a month before the abdication.
Edward VIII. He heard about Jack and he couldn't leave the country quick enough.
What is it? Sleep in the back. Listen, this isn't going away. Not now, not ever.
I'm here for Jack's birthday, not you.
Really?
Yes,
happy birthday to you.
Oh,
happy birthday, Jack.
I've been smelt rotten today.
That's because people love you.
Never mind me. Did you manage to patch things up with your Ashley?
I tried.
You didn't try hard enough.
Hey, you must have seen a few things in your time in here, Jack.
You saw a lot of things down that cellar when you were a pot mum.
Like what?
State secrets.
Racing gazette ball like you.
Oh, game over.
You never did a day's work down there, love.
I was too busy dreaming about you, Betty.
Josh was asking how long it was till Christmas.
Halloween, bonfire night, Christmas. It's just one expense after another with kids.
Who'd have on, eh?
Oh, look.
Hey. Now, we couldn't fit on 74 individual candles, so we've done the next best thing.
Oh. Hey. Bit of that, Sean.
Listen, I might be 90, but I'm still the Delia Smith round here.
Blow the candles out, then.
Come on.
I don't know what I've done to deserve all this, but when you've ducked and dived as much as I have, you kind of learn to say no when you've been dealt a decent hand for once. I'd like to thank you all for your friendship for the past 30-odd years or so. And it's a pity out of here I can't be here, but we can't have everything, though, can we? I'd like to thank Connie for putting up with it as long as she has. Thank you. And Tyrone and Molly for being like my son and my daughter.
Yeah.
And I am so chuffed about that little lad, because He'll be here long after I've gone. So for me, he is the future.
Yeah.
So, raising your glasses to Molly, Tyrone.
Yeah.
And little Jack.
Molly. Molly.
Cheers, man.
Cheers, kid.
We could give it a miss tonight. No, because then it's going to actually look like we've got something to hide. Look, Shan, Rosie's right. We've got to be upfront about it.
Oh, no way.
What are we going to say when he asks us what we was doing?
Well, that we're madly in love and there's nothing he can do about it, so naffer.
Hi.
Can I come in?
Yeah, sure.
Shan?
Hi.
Mum and Dad not in?
No, they're still at work.
I was just wondering if we should have a little chat before we meet this evening.
Look, if it was about the other night, then...
It is, actually.
OK, well, the thing was, my sister Rosie organised it, and it just got way out of hand.
Yeah,
and...
so I saw. It's that we need to talk about.
Excuse me, ladies.
Oh, yes, certainly,
Jack. Jack's such a lovely man.
Yeah. Threw away them all when they made him.
He had his fair share of problems with Ira, of course.
Yeah.
They always managed to work him out.
It helps when you're agreed on which country you want to live in.
It helps when you're not pretending to have a serious illness.
It helps when you don't force something on your partner that he doesn't want.
And it helps when you're not being held back by someone who wants to live in a slum for the rest of their life.
This was very naughty.
So, Tyrone, did you notice it?
Where's little whippersnapper?
In the back, having a sleep.
Then yourself up so we can give you the runaround again, eh?
It was very nice what you said about us.
I meant every word of it. Your happiness means everything to me. Which is why I've been a bit down in the dumps since yesterday.
Why? What's happened?
Well, I was wondering whether I mentioned that or not, but you could always tell me. It's none of my business.
Go on, just say it.
It's about the baby. You know, I wish I hadn't have been there and I couldn't help overhearing yesterday in the house, you and Kevin. I know he's the father. What is going to happen, Molly?
And Coronation Street is back in half an hour.
I've let you down.
You haven't let me down.
I have.
You know how much I think.
And so do I.
Do you?
It was a mistake, Jack.
Well, I was never a saint. Neither was Vera come at that, though she might have you believed different.
Hey, well, we needn't speak ill of the dead.
I'm not speaking ill of a lot.
You stuck together, though, didn't you?
See, I know he's soft, he's daft, he's a few rungs short of a ladder sometimes, but he is the very best of men, he's my Tyrone.
I know he is.
Better than anything I could spawn.
Well, he's got the duck with Jean one way or another.
How's he, heck? He'd never do what I did, what Terry did. What you've done.
It was over a long, long time ago and it was stupid.
Do you know, I can barely look Sally in the eye.
Jack, please.
One thing we managed, me and Alvira, despite everything. Despite a run of bad luck lasting 40 flaming years. Was we cared about each other.
I care about Tyrone.
Well, then move away from here, and I don't care if it's Oldham or Ontario.
I really do love him, Jack.
You see, I want you both to be happy. And if he doesn't make you happy, if you've got the slightest doubt, then you must tell him the truth and let him... live a life worth living.
It won't come to that.
Baby Jack is Kevin and I'm so angry I could...
I know.
You will do the right thing, though. You promise me that.
I promise.
Oh, come here. is a rotten world, Moll.
Because of this, God gave them over to shameful lusts. Even their women exchanged natural relations for unnatural ones.
Shameful?
Yeah, don't worry about the language.
Yeah, but unnatural, though, come on, you can't get away with that these days.
Exactly, it's well out of date.
Of course it is, I know. But what Paul is talking about, in a more general sense, is sin. When people abandon God in greed or in anger, in deceit.
So it's up there with deceit, our relationship?
Look, these are impulses most of us are guilty of countless times a day.
But we haven't abandoned God.
I know, feelings aren't condemned. The trick is not to act on them. Sometimes we have to sacrifice our own desires to honour him.
Look, I might be a funny hearer out, but if you heard yourself...
What, do I sound stuffy? It's a modern world, I know that. And I know that some people choose to live this way.
See, I thought that it was all equal, but I must have misunderstood that.
God puts temptation in our way to test us, to make us prove our love for him.
Well, I don't think you're as modern as you think you are.
Chan.
No! It's all good and well when he's got us rocking out to shackles.
Chan.
Look, I know this is difficult, but the church isn't rejecting you.
It isn't.
Look, things have moved on, okay? God got it wrong and he'd be the first one to admit it.
So that's it. Oh, have you got him down?
Oh, yeah, yeah. One verse a little donkey was well gone. Which is look at, because I don't hold the second verse.
I could do with you at bedtime.
Hey, now you, he's spoken for.
Well, I'm suffering terribly at the moment.
Well, what pills are you taking?
Oh, I've tried everything. Oh.
Pills make it worse, don't you find?
Well, there's more pressure on yourself, isn't there, once you're taking something?
Hey, you're the best chorus for insomnia.
Good night's
sleep.
Hey, baby, I could do the rounds, eh? The sleep doctor. Oh, no, no. The sleep whisperer.
Else get wits out of him tiptoeing out bedrooms.
I usually have the most marvellous preventative medicine, you see. Half an hour with Norris and I'm exhausted.
So, what's in, Ty? Moses' basket?
No, no, I've just thrown him on the sofa, but he'd be reek.
Yeah, that's my godson you're making jokes about.
I'm only having a laugh, Kev.
Yeah, what kids need looking after? I used to watch my girls like Hawk dinner self.
Could you keep it down just a smidgen?
Yes, a lot more.
I believe drunk Kevin Webster, like Peter used to get.
Ashley just gets soppy.
What sort of a drunk were Vera?
Amorous, Audrey, very amorous.
I'm just the opposite. I just want to go to sleep.
Mm. I don't think I've ever seen Kevin like this.
Doesn't take much for these youngsters, does he? When I think when I used to put away. I've spilt more than he could sup.
Are you all right, Kevin?
I'm sorry, Sean. You got a dustpan and brush and I'll sweep up for you.
I'll clear it up, Sean.
No, no, no. We don't want a lawsuit on our hands.
Sorry. Do you think he's had enough?
I'm trying.
Hey, Jack Duckworth, let me buy you a big fat cigar.
No, I'm okay, Kevin.
Oh, come on, mate. Me and you, eh? Smoke a couple of stogies, talk about the good old days.
I said no thanks very much.
All right, keep your hair on.
Kevin, come on, you're making a show of yourself.
Woo! Anyone fancy curry?
I do. Now, come on, let's go.
Curry?
Oh, yes.
Oh,
there you go, girls.
Well, hello.
Oh. Celebration, is it?
All right. Jack Duckworth, one of our regulars.
Ah, free bar then.
Nice try.
Christopher.
No, I'll get this.
Oh, no, get the old man a drink, will you?
I don't even know him.
Well, sure. Hmm?
Someone wants his daddy.
Oh, is he awake?
Yeah.
Come here then, my little prince.
Hello.
Such a complete failure to... I don't know.
Communicate?
Exactly.
Communication's the most important thing in a marriage.
Every conversation we have just turns into an argument. Whatever I'm doing, she's hitting me up, yapping down my ears.
What's the mean trick you played on her, though?
Angiana Gay, I know it was. But I've apologised. I only did it for a bit of respite.
Do you know what Len did once to get out of an ear bashing? He played dead. Well, that was even meaner.
Did it work?
Oh, it frightened the living daylights out of me, I can tell you that much. But when I realised he wasn't dead, I was that relieved the argument was forgotten.
It's funny, isn't it, the things that we do.
Here we go.
Oh,
is Jack going?
Yeah, as quietly as he can.
bit of a fuss, really, isn't it, for 74? I mean, 75, yeah, I can understand, but 74?
That's what Deirdre said.
Hey, here he is.
Hey.
Happy birthday, Jack.
Oh, thank you, Peter. Thank you.
Yeah, many happy returns.
Say it with a kiss, darling.
Go on, then.
Hey, you've still got it.
We never lose it. By gum, that's one hell of a woman you got there, Peter.
Oh, no, she's not mine, Jack. It's Leanne, you remember?
Of course. How did we go on at Carlisle?
Oh, you'll have to pop in tomorrow, I can't remember. Anyway, what are you having?
No, I'm full of... You carry on.
All right, anyway, all the best.
And you, Peter, and you.
Hey.
Hi.
Big 7-4.
Hi.
Expect him to be over the moon. I wasn't expecting that. Where's the support? Where's the compassion? We're not thick. We know it isn't wrong or against God's wishes.
Well, he wasn't making it up, Shine. He was reading it from the Bible.
Oh, so do you think God doesn't want us?
I don't know. I think God wants everyone.
Even the shameful, unnatural perverts inflamed with lust and immoral desires.
Shine, it's not a joke,
isn't it? I'm struggling to take it all seriously. Joe, I was stunned by that rubbish, and I don't like the way it's got to you.
Yeah, well, it has, okay.
We're not going back there, so.
We're not even welcome.
Right, so, what's next?
What a big turnout, isn't it?
I found this popular, I mean.
Hey, you're not this popular now.
Your group is on. Which one's his missus?
Well, that's his fancy piece over there. His wife, Vera, died a few years back.
Right, what would you prefer? Another wife? What a fancy piece.
It's all right, Owen, I'm not listening.
Yeah, I don't know, Chris. It's not the type of question I concern myself with.
Oh, well, I'm slipping off now. Norris is cooking, and I don't want to make him late.
Oh, in that case, I'd stay and have another drink. I think I'd better be making a move as well.
Oh, well, can I just thank you on behalf of Jack? Big Jack, that is. He's had a fantastic afternoon, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Although I think he'd had his fill, and, well, he's not one for goodbyes.
He snuck off for a smoke. Thinks you're all daft.
Well, if he has, I suppose he's entitled.
Yeah.
Suppose he is, yeah, but you know what? Do you know we're not stung for it? But he's a jolly good fellow.
I hope Claire and Ashley sort out their differences.
Audrey, I know Deirdre said this more than once, but... she really is very sorry about what happened.
She did me a favour, Cam. Life is so much simpler on your own.
Hey, Dad, look at us two playing the field, eh?
Hey, enough of that. It's only because Deirdre's babysitting. And soon I'll hear old winter's song. But I miss you. Most of all, my darling, when autumn leaves start to fall. It's not like you. I know you're uncouthed, but honestly.
I'm all right. Where's our sofa?
Got a couple of wedding meals in the freezer.
What? Curries?
Yeah, sticking with the spirit of the evening.
Hey, they should have served us, you know. I'm going to go back there somewhere and complain.
You're not going anywhere near it.
I had the menu in my hand. I knew what I wanted.
You were singing.
I was humming.
I don't know what's got into you tonight.
I'm enjoying myself, I told you.
Yeah, well, you've embarrassed yourself, you've embarrassed me, you embarrassed Jack Duckworth on his birthday.
Oh, go off it, woman. It'll take more than a drunkard in a curry house to make Jack Duckworth blush.
You actually admire him.
Yeah, he's all right, Jack.
Is that what you aspire to be?
Oh, be quiet. I want to sleep.
So am I putting these curries in or not?
You know what I fancy eating? Crisps.
Oh,
Oh, my. I'm tired for you.
Well, put your paper down and come with me.
It'd be all right if I stopped here.
Look at the state of that collar. Is it too much effort to go and look in the mirror?
Are you waiting for me, my swan dog?
Of course I'm waiting for you. There's a bus at 12 minutes past, so come on, shift yourself.
Oh, give us up a chance.
Never mind that.
Oh, no. Hang fire.
Let
while the music's playing.
What are you on about?
Come here. Oh.
When did you go soft?
Give you 3 guesses.
As I leave you there, as I leave you there, as I leave.
All the best now.
Oh, thanks, Rita.
All the best.
Oh, and Sean, thank Liz again for them drinks.
Will do.
I'm going to bob back with you, Tyrone. Say bye-bye to him.
Yeah, of course.
If he's there, there is. He couldn't have made it round to a flying horse on his own, could he?
Yeah, I thought that.
I doubt it. He'll be fast asleep in that chair. You wait and see.
Yeah, okay, bye now.
Bye.
Cheers.
Bye.
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 Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Cheers. Bye. Thanks. Bye. Bye. Cheers.
Bye. Another birthday comes, another birthday comes.
But didn't you think it was odd, Rita? I mean, a gathering like this just for 74?
They're all an achievement, if you ask me.
Right, well, better go and get me boy. God knows what's happened to Leanne. Back.
Pretty, I was enjoying myself.
Hey, has anyone seen the Thomas the Tank Engine?
Oh.
Didn't
say that, did
you? Oh, he's here.
Oh, thank goodness for that.
Just thought you'd wandered off into it tonight. Well, to flying horse, any road. Bookies were shut, you see. Been right off the flying horse anyway, has been for years. I'll put these cards up here for you, mate. Might have to put some string up like at Christmas. I've never seen so many cards.
Tyrone, love.
What's the matter?
Connie?
Oh, dear. Oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear.
Ty, phone a doctor. Phone an ambulance.
No, I'll do that.
Has he gone?
Oh, I'm so sorry, Tyrone.
Should I put him upstairs?
Thanks, but I'm not hungry.
Oh, at least try and eat something. You've got to keep your strength up.
Sorry if we disturbed you in the night. He was proper fractious.
I couldn't settle anyway. Oh, I dreamed I'd lost my handbag. Oh, it were terrible. Everything I treasured were in the bag.
It's too soon, that's what gets me. I mean, we'd not finished, me and Jack. We still had loads of stuff to talk about, stuff to do.
I know, love.
Promised to take him to the last race at season.
Oh, he said he were pleased as punch about that.
Who's going to take Rita?
Cabin Rita?
No, racy Rita. His new pigeon.
I've already got him the tickets and everything.
Well, you could still go, take a mate, eh?
Won't be the same without Jack. Nothing's ever going to be the same.
I know.
Never even got a chance to say goodbye.
Sorry about last night.
that bad, was I?
Any consolation? I'm totally wrecked. Hangover from hell.
Sam, something's happened. It's Jack.
Well, the baby? Is something...
No. The baby's fine. It's, Jack Duckworth. He passed away last night.
I suppose if you're gonna go, that's the way to do it, isn't it? Halfway through your own birthday party, surrounded by your mates.
I think he knew, because he sort of snuck off by himself back home.
Is that where it happened?
Sat in his favourite chair.
You know, thinking back, it's a bit funny with me at the do. Maybe you felt weird or something.
No. That's not why.
No?
No. It's because he knew about us.
You're kidding.
He heard you telling me that the baby's yours. Thought he'd hate me for what I've done. But he didn't. It hurt like you wouldn't believe, and he still didn't judge me. I didn't deserve his kindness.
Please tell me. He didn't say out to anyone.
Typical. Some things never change, do they? Everything's always about you. Tyrone's over there, he's breaking his heart because the closest thing he's got to a dad has gone forever. He's like a little lad. He doesn't know where to put himself. Do you care? Do you, Elle?
Of course I do. It's just...
Oh, you can relax. Jack kept it to himself because he was a lovely, decent man. A man who'd rather die than hurt anyone.
He's a beautiful boy, eh? Who's Daddy's best boy? Who's Daddy's best boy, eh? You are. Yes, you are.
Oh, look. Jack didn't even get to open half his prezzies.
I know. Someone got him some electric nose hair clippers. He'd left his socks off at that. I just keep expecting him to walk through that door. Larger than life and twice as ugly, as he says. As he used to say.
Is it all right? I don't want to impose.
No, you're fine. Come in.
I hope you don't mind.
No worries.
Tyrone, I'm so sorry. You must be knocked for six. I'll put the kettle on there. Am I right in saying you've got some Ettles cakes in this cupboard?
Oh, you'll have to check the sell by day. They might have gone stale. Oh, I'll get it. Come in.
Jack's got more cards than we have in cabin.
He's got a lot of friends round here, as Jack.
I know it's hard to believe right now. Honestly, it will get easier, I promise. At least you've got your lovely little son to keep you going.
Yeah.
Just the postman.
Do you take sugar, Rita?
No, thanks, love.
Oh, Rita.
Oh, lovey. What is it? Oh. Did you ever see a happier man in all your days? Oh, he's bursting with pride, bless him.
I'm going to miss him.
I know, love, we all are. But isn't it good to know he spent his last precious days with his dearest friends? Just imagine, Tyrone, what it meant to him to see you two all happy and settled with your lovely baby, a proper little family. Jack Duckworth died happy. We should take some comfort from that.
Babe?
Sorry, mate, you must be gutted. Devastated. Totally devastated. And then some.
Have a seat.
Do you want a cup of tea, love? I think we've drunk enough to sink a battleship today.
yeah, cheers, love. Two sugars. It's a lovely photo.
Yeah.
Listen, why don't you come down to the Rovers later to have a few bevvies on the house?
Oh, I don't know.
Well, you know, just drown your sorrows a bit of the old liquid anaesthetic.
Well, that's nice, isn't it, Tyrone? After all, that place was Jack's second home.
Exactly. Exactly. Just pop in if you fancy it. You're always welcome.
Well, we might. Tell the truth. Not sure how long I can sit here just looking at that chair where it happened.
Yeah, thank you, Betty.
Oh, thank you, dear.
Oh, here they are. Oh, I am glad you've come.
Yeah. We're all here for you, no loves.
He couldn't keep us awake. He was a lovely man.
Do you know, we've lost count of the times he had us in stitches behind this bar.
Usual, mate.
Aye. We're so sorry. If there's anything we can do.
How you doing, mate?
You must be in shock.
Yeah, I think we are a bit. If there's anything we can do, just say.
Aye. You need your friends round you at a time like this.
Listen, I've been thinking about Jack and everything, and, I wanted to do something to pay homage to him.
All right.
So, what did he love in the world more than anything, apart from you, Vera?
His pigeons.
And?
Betty.
What else?
I believe he had a bit of an eye for the ladies when he was younger.
Beer. He loved his beer, didn't he?
Yeah, of course he did.
So, I've been on the phone to the brewery, and we're going to have a barrel of beer named after him.
Oh, he'd be well chuffed at that.
It'll be a well in time for the funeral, so... can raise a toast to him.
Thanks, though.
Name one of his pigeons after you, you know.
Well, I've heard everything now.
Racy Rita.
It's a good job he's not here. I give him a clout for his trouble.
It's a good job Liz isn't here. She'd have chucked you around your ear.
Oh, are you going to turn a blind eye then?
You sit there.
Thanks.
Three wise monkeys me rolled into one. Seen out, hearing out, saying out.
Is that right?
Oh, yeah. Anything to keep the peace. It's like the VIP tickets Nick here gave us.
Oh, yeah? What about him?
Well, I knew that Liz wouldn't be best pleased seeing me fraternise with the enemy, so I gave him to my right-hand man, Chris.
Oh, you are.
Wish he was a builder, mate. Should have been a diplomat.
Don't worry, but we'll make a habit of that. Listen, I'm sorry about Jack, mate. He was a great fella, he really was. I'll tell you something else as well. My takings are going to take a right hammering. Yeah.
What's this?
Jack put a bet on yesterday. His horse came in. 3-1 on Meet Thy Maker. Can you believe that? Anyway.
All right, mate. Yeah. I'm okay, you know.
How are you bearing up, Tyrone? No, I think you're dead brave coming here tonight. If it were me, I'd be tempted to just stop at home and wallow.
Well, I wasn't sure, but I'm glad I did now.
Good that we come out together. As a couple.
I'm here to pay my respects to Jack.
Come on, Claire, we can't carry on like this.
Who said we're going to carry on at all?
You know, that's what Jack wanted for us.
Yeah, I know. I don't want to talk about this right now.
We're proper happy, me and you. How's it come to this?
Oh, I dealt with the situation very badly. I fear I've upset Sophie terribly. She caught you on the hop, that's all. Now that a few kind words can't put right, the world's moved on. Yet I feel as though I stopped somewhere around 1966. Don't be daft.
No, we're a dying breed, Rita.
The last of the dinosaurs.
Oh, you speak for yourself.
You've always been much more broad-minded than me.
Emily Bishop, are you saying I'm a fool?
Oh, dear. Oh, we shouldn't be laughing. Now, you listen to me, lady. You're one of the kindest people I've ever met. And I know for a fact, once you get your head round all this, you'll be able to deal with Sophie and Sham with the utmost wisdom and compassion. You think on.
You glad you came?
Yeah.
Hey, you're not still thinking about that thing with Emily, are you? I just thought she'd understand.
Yeah, well, why would she?
Because she's known me forever, and I just thought she cared.
Look, she's a different generation, okay? And lesbians probably didn't even exist in her day.
Yeah, right.
I mean, that they must have stayed hidden and kept the shameful secrets for themselves.
Yeah, well, I'm starting to wish that we would have kept our gob shut now.
So, yeah, it was Jack going round leaving gifts for people.
So, Jack paid for the church roof to be fixed. He was the mystery benefactor.
Yeah, he was. And he was the one that put the theatre tickets from my letterbox.
And that time I got champagne and flowers from my friend.
Yeah, that was him too.
Oh, I wish I'd have had the time to say thank you. Gee, bless him. He was a kind old soul when he put his mind to it.
I won't be sad.
Steve,
can you get us a pickled egg?
Yeah.
hiding in there all night. You've hardly said a word to Tyrone.
Yeah, it's not that easy, though, is it? I'm sick to death of being a hypocrite, pretending I'm his best mate and all the time.
How the hell do you think I feel?
I like to think he's up there now, sitting next to Vera, in a string vest.
And her in her housecoat with the curlers in her hair, eh?
A pair of them bickering like mad.
The end of an era, is this? Let's raise our glasses to Jack. Kind neighbour, wonderful friend, and a right rum un. To Jack Duck.
You've lost someone you love. Your head's all over the place.
I lied to Jack. I told him that I loved Tyrone because I hated myself and I knew it was what he wanted to hear.
You do love him, in your own way.
Yeah. And doesn't that just say it all? Tyrone deserves better.
He wants you. He wants the baby. He's happy.
But none of it's real. I'm just not sure how much longer I can go on living like this.
Well, I'm sure I'll have a better idea tomorrow.
Thank you.
Thanks.
That was Michael from the funeral directors. I've just told him you were at work.
What have you told him that for?
Well, because I knew you wouldn't want to talk to him.
Oh, well, what's he going to think?
Doesn't matter what he thinks.
You may as well have told him I was in the pub.
He's going to want decisions and I don't think you're ready.
What decisions?
Just all sorts of stuff. You can't even put a notice in the Gazette until you've decided on a time and a date for the service.
Wednesday's bowls, Tuesday morning's allotment committee, Tuesday afternoon's dominoes, and they're all going to want to be there.
And they all will be there, no matter what it clashes with. But you want to get it right, don't you?
Yeah, it's got to be right.
So, I think we should just give you a break. We'll tuck these away for now. And we'll tell whoever asked the F word is banned for today. Agreed?
Hey, love.
Oh. I thought you'd gone for a walk.
You know, if Bill Webster popped his clogs today, God forbid, I'd be round at Kev's like a shot. He's not even stepped foot in here.
Bill.
Kevin.
Well, you saw him in the Rovers.
Yeah, along with 100 mates and neighbours. I'm talking about one-on-one paying your respects in private. He's not even sent me a text, Molly. It's out of order.
Are you really upset? You know, Kevin.
Thought I did.
He's not exactly in touch with his feelings, is he? He'll be embarrassed a bit in case you cry or he does.
Just thought he was a bigger man, that's all.
Well, I'm sorry, love.
Me and all.
You got two options. Fester, get even more worked up. Or you go round there.
What, and make it easy for him?
And show him what true class looks like. So,
mate, you beat me to it. Been meaning to come across. Dickinson's delivered those parts you ordered to Webster's garage in Brighton. I've had Ann Miller on the board about this flaming people carrier. But you've been on my mind, mate, since...
Yeah, well, life gets in the way, eh? Still, if the mountain won't come to Mohammed.
How are you bearing up?
Dunno. All feels like a dream, if I'm honest. But I can have a look at this people carrier while I'm here.
Yeah, it's supposed to be morning.
Jack, I don't understand.
You volunteering for work, he'd be spinning in his grave.
Yeah, he would. Except I've not even picked out his coffin yet.
Oh, perfect timing. I didn't think Molly would be in the mood for cooking. Actually, I didn't think she did cook, but anyway.
No fuss, we said. Keep things normal.
Well, it's a bit more normal than a beef stew. We were going to invite you round to us, Tyrone, but just to let you know that we're thinking about you, aren't we?
I've told you.
Oh, there's enough for 10 of us here. Come and share it.
No.
Come on.
No, I've taken up enough of your time this afternoon.
If you're doing us a favour, give us a lift having people at the house.
Look, I was just saying that.
No, I mean it. I don't like it when it's too quiet. Gives you too much time to think. So many choices. A hearse and one car, or a hearse and two cars. Wreaths coming out your ears, or family flowers only. Or a charity donation, cancer research, or pigeon protection leave.
We said we weren't going to fret about the funeral today.
You know, you're not going to rest till this funeral's over, though.
Do you know, it makes me angry. Jack's got a son and a grandson. It should be their responsibility.
It's not a responsibility. It's an honour.
Do you know, I've known the Duckies since they were 18. I've seen Terry flit in and out. Girlfriends and grandsons come and go, and they only had one duty to Jack, and that was to make him happy. And the only person who managed that, Tyrone, was you.
And everyone knows it.
So, oak or a paper coffin, sausage rolls or vol-au-vents, Jack could tell you, just get the list, shut your eyes and stick a pin in it. Because you've done what counts. You let him die at peace with himself and the world. Am I right, Kevin?
Yeah.
I sometimes think they had it better in Jack and Vera's day.
What, when women did all the work?
All the work and all the child rearing. But they've got to make all the decisions and all. What have we got today? The myth of equality.
Aye, aye.
Endless debate. I want a blue sofa. He wants a brown sofa. And what do we end up with? A green sofa that we both like the least.
Her couch is beige.
So literal, honestly.
We agree on most things, don't we?
Yeah, well, mark my words, you'll end up doing the lion's share of the child rearing.
Over my dead body.
Ah, but that's where good friends come in. Because 4 o'clock in the morning, 4 o'clock in the afternoon, makes no odds. You were there for Jack, we'll be there for you.
How much have you had to drink?
Not enough.
You can talk after the other night. Do you know what? I never got a wink of sleep with his boozy snoring, no matter how many times I elbowed him to turn over.
Little Jack's nose, you know.
Never.
Listen, security's thing.
Kev, will you stop clattering?
Just trying to help.
Take Sally upstairs, you can't hear it on the monitor. You just need to get your act together.
I'm doing my best.
Well, it's not good enough. Not coming round to pay your respects.
It's doing me head in. All this talk about Jack's peaceful death.
Yeah. Well, that's our fault. Our burden. We can't pass it on to other people.
I don't intend to.
But you will if you carry on behaving like this, acting all out of character. Folk get suspicious. Please, I'm begging you. Forget about me and the baby. If you've got any love for Tyrone, if you care for him half as much as Jack Duckworth did, you will forget that DNA test. Just forget that you and I ever spent a moment in each other's company.
And how do I do that?
Be a man. Jack was. He didn't judge us. It hurt, but he took our secrets to the grave. We've got to do the same. I don't want your casseroles. I want you to rewrite the past. You and me never happened.
Just like that. I'm supposed to forget his mind. Just like that.
You dumped me just like that. Tommy Cooper had nothing on you. Okay, plan B then. We'll come clean. Devastation all around. Tyrone, Sally, Rosie, Sophie. But you'll get to play daddy at the weekends. We'll tell them now if you like. Or we can wait till Jack's 6 feet under. It's up to you. Yeah, anything for a quiet life, eh?
Didn't realise you hated me so much.
It's called self-preservation.
Fair enough. But pretending is not mine. Every time I see him, it just churns me up. I've got all this love inside and I don't know what to do with it.
I've got a funeral to organise. A broken-hearted husband. A son that I intend to lie to for the rest of his life. A decade of a big fat lie right ahead of me. Have you any suggestions of where I put that?
No. Okay. I'll try.
I mean it, Kevin. You need to be Oscar-winning. No more weirdness, no more moody silences. You treat baby Jack like he is your best mate's son, because that's all he ever can be.
Hey. All right, little fella.
Yeah, we've got a confession to make. I'll walk him up.
It didn't seem right, him up there all on his lonesome.
No, just a few gentle prods.
What are you two like?
We're gonna have a good laugh with champ.
Oh, book me in for one of them. Hey, believe it or not, our Rosie was a dead cuddly baby, wasn't she, Kev?
Yeah. Right, it's time we was going.
Oh, there's a few more cans in the fridge. Stop for a bit.
Yeah, okay. I've never knowingly refused ale.
Mm-hmm. Nice one.
Oh. You always end up doing jobs when you come round.
Hey, that's what aunties are for.
Ties spark out on the bed.
You both look shattered. Kevin didn't look too clever either. Are you and him,
dead and buried?
I hope they're into boat.
Auntie Pam, it's such a mess. Kevin's Jack's father.
Oh, now, you don't know that, Molly. Why talk to yourself?
He went and did a DNA test.
You what?
I didn't know anything about it until afterwards. He took a dummy from the christening and paid for a test. Kevin is 100% definitely my baby's dad.
Oh, good Lord. Sneaking off with a dummy. He's so grubby, so self-serving.
He said he just had to know. It was driving him mad.
Who else knows?
Poor old Jack. Sorry. He overheard us talking about the results. Like he didn't have enough to worry about with the cancer.
Hey, come on. Come.
Bet you're glad you came.
Don't say I'm, don't be daft. And that Jack Duckworth, he's been round the block more times than you've had a chippy tea.
He was brilliant. He could have made me feel like dirt, but he was dead straight. He just said that if Tyrone wasn't the one, then I should tell him and let him find someone else.
What did you say?
That Ty's the one. I know that I don't deserve him, but I do love him.
I know that. And Tyrone knows that. And Jack knew that, God rest his gentle soul. Molly, love. You made a mistake. God knows you're paying a high price for it.
Everything I say just feels like a lie. When we're in bed, and, you know, and afterwards when he's holding me, I just get this terrible urge to tell him. I want to tell him. And then he can hate me as much as I hate myself.
Oh, come here. Come on. It's all right. Oh,
I feel so self-pitying. I feel so selfish. Jack's lying cold in the chapel arrest and I'm here crying for myself.
I bet you hid them weapons of mass destruction and all.
Everything that comes out my mouth feels like a lie.
Look, you love your husband and you love your baby. True or false?
True.
Right. And you and the husband that you love and regret cheating on are going to lavish that baby with all the love in the world. True or false?
True.
Right. So whenever you get the urge to come clean, you pick up that phone, day or night, and I'll talk you out of it in 2 seconds flat.
Hiya.
Oh, hi, Connie. Do you want a brew?
It's fine, I'll do it.
He's got some lovely cards.
Yeah, I know. Can't believe how many people he knew.
Well, when you reach our age, they mount up. Well, them that haven't gone before, that is. So, anything I can do to help you? Well,
the vicar wants to know what hymns we want. What do you think, Mol?
I don't know.
Trouble is, he never really liked hymns. He always said that they was dead dreary.
Well, perhaps we should keep them down to a minimum.
You reckon?
Yeah. Where's Jack's funeral, not vicar's?
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, the important thing is to do things the way that he wanted, innit?
Yeah, I'm just going to go and check on Jack.
Mol?
I'm fine.
She's took it hard, hasn't she?
Yeah. Do you think I should go?
No, give her a bit of space. Some folks cope by keeping busy. Now, all this talk we've had about the funeral, there's one thing you've never mentioned.
What?
Terry.
Yeah, I know.
Well, have you been in touch with him yet?
No.
It's only 2 days.
But it's hard enough telling him that his dad's died, but to tell him that you didn't want him at the funeral... It just seems a bit harsh.
What? Do you want me to do it?
No, it's all right.
Listen, if you feel it's the wrong decision, I'm sure Jack would have respect your judgment. So you just do what you think is right.
Yeah, it was like she couldn't even look at us. I swear, it's like we had some kind of disease, like she couldn't get out there quick enough.
Oh, are you still going on about that? It's Emily Bishop. Who cares what she thinks?
Yeah, but it's not just Emily Bishop, is it? It's the pastor and all, and now I can't even go to church.
Yeah, because you think we'll probably corrupt the rest of him.
It's not fair. I like going quiet and all.
Me too. Dad, how much butter have you actually put on that?
Oh, sorry.
Oh, so you listen to her?
I do not, but listen to everyone. My opinions count for now.
Do you actually know, though, how many calories is in a teaspoon of butter?
Well, don't eat it with a teaspoon, then.
Come on, Charlie.
Hi.
Oh, hiya. Feeling better now?
Yeah, yeah.
She was really upset this morning over Jack. Yeah, Jack, you know, not the baby.
Yeah, yeah, but I'm fine now. So, you rung Terry yet?
No.
Ty, you can't keep putting it off.
I know.
What's this?
Oh, well, Jack didn't want Terry to be at his funeral, so he's scared of phoning him.
Oh, no, I'm not scared. It's hard, that's all.
Yeah, and just get it over with, eh?
Yeah, you're right, I'll do it now.
Ah, suppose there's a lot to sort.
Yeah.
Always is with funerals.
Yep.
Hello, is that Terry? Yeah, it's Tyrone Dobbs, Jack's lodger. Got some bad news, I'm afraid.
Well, I'll leave you to it. I'll get back.
Sorry? No, I don't know if there's a will. He's not even been buried yet. No, don't worry. We'll sort all that. Won't want to put you out. Well, it's Thursday, but the thing is... All right, I see. Yeah. Yeah, it is a long way. No, you're right. It's not like he'll know you weren't there. All right, bye.
All right, mate. Did you tell him he'd not come?
Didn't need to. Wasn't going to come anyway. Just came out with a load of pathetic excuses. But you know what it boils down to? That he didn't give a jot. His own father, Jack, deserved better than that.
And he had better in you.
Yeah, but I wasn't his flesh and blood.
Doesn't matter, Ty. He was a good son to him. Like you're going to be a smashing dad to young Jack.
Hi, love. Busy day.
Yes, love.
I've decided we are going to choir practice tonight.
Oh, do you think that's wise?
Well, why shouldn't we?
You're right, actually. He's the one at fault, not us.
Exactly, and we've got nothing to be ashamed of.
Why don't you just knock it on the head?
What?
Religion.
Don't be so stupid, Rosie. You can't just wake up one morning and stop believing.
Well, if you had any sense, you would. It's all a load of rubbish.
Rosie!
How would you know? You have never read a Bible in your entire life.
Well, you can't have read it very carefully because you know what it says.
Was St. Paul, not Jesus!
We won't just shut up!
Kevin!
I'd like a bit of peace in my own house. Is that too much to ask?
You're both going to the funeral and that's that.
Oh, but please, Mum, it'll just be so depressing.
Oh, sorry, love. I'll see if Ty can line up a couple of clowns, shall I? I might even do my Bez impression. That'll be a laugh, won't it?
No, Dad, I didn't mean it like that. I love Chad to bits, but I just don't think it's right to remember someone like that in a sad way.
Well, I'm sure it'll be a celebration of his life. That's what Jack would have wanted.
Well, I'm just glad it's at a crematorium.
Oh, and why is that?
Kevin?
No, we've heard from the drama queen. Let the lady of the broken record have her say. Come on, cat got your tongue.
I'm not speaking to you when you're like that.
Well, we're just a bit sensitive about religious surroundings.
Sensitive? A man's dead. Tyrone's lost the only father he's ever known. And you're worried about yourselves. This might come as a shock to you, but the world doesn't revolve around you, Sharon.
Dad!
I should go and get my dad. The stew was lovely, thank you, Sally.
Why? Are you so hurtful?
Oh, my God.
I know you're in a mood, but there's no need to take it out on her.
Look, the girl needs a wake-up call. If she doesn't like it, she knows what she can do. I've got the Rovers.
And what about your tea?
I'll have it later.
Oh. Jason, Yuri's been arrested. Someone tried to mess with another fair maiden.
So much for sitting round as a family.
Look, if she goes, I go.
No one is going anywhere. Your dad's just upset because of Jack. No matter what happens, we're behind you and Sian 100%.
There's no doubt about it, son. You pull a fair pint in here, so you do. Hey, listen. What's the crack with your mother? She got a fella on the go or what?
Beat around the bush, why don't you?
Subtle as a sledgehammer.
I'm curious as all, that's, you know what I mean? I mean, can a man take an interest in his loved ones?
The last time you took an interest, you ended up knocking Vernon out.
Ah, sure, your man had it coming to him, so he did.
Oh, look, I'm on your side.
Oh, well, you could have fooled me.
Look, all I'm saying is my mum's business is her business. That's it, understood.
Well, so much for the bond between the father and the son. I mean, I bet your girls share everything with you, eh?
Oh, yes. Big on sharing. Can't get enough of it.
Uh-huh. Giving you some grief, are they?
No more than normal.
Are you sure? You're looking a bit down, so you are.
Nah, I'm just a bit cut up over Jack, that's all.
I was one in a million, Jackal. A man of rare wit and wisdom. And an old-fashioned chancery boot.
I'm proud to hear you say that.
Well, not as proud as I am, you've known him. Oh,
take five, everyone. Sophie, Sian, this is a surprise.
Why? It's Monday night practice, where else would we be?
We are still part of the choir.
Unless you know something we don't.
Why don't we take this into the study room?
Whatever you've got to say, you can say it here, because we've got nothing to hide.
Clearly.
Got a feeling we're freaking him out.
Please, I'm not seeking a confrontation here.
No, but you'd rather we weren't lesbians, right?
Whatever you think you are.
Come again? Whatever we think we are?
I didn't mean that.
Well, I'll tell you something we ain't, okay? We're not an abomination. We're not some narrow-minded, homophobic bigot.
That's enough. This is a church, not some soapbox for your politically correct shout-outs.
What happened to everyone having their voice?
Our voices are given to us so that we may worship God, not ourselves. But please, you must understand. Our belief and faith is built upon a foundation of shared values. Without unity of purpose, without harmony, we're lost.
So in other words, you want us to all be the same? Well, I'm sorry, but we can't live by your rule. And you know what? You know what's sad about all this? You talk about God speaking to you. You only hear what you want to hear. You're the loser in all this, not us.
I can't find my black tie.
Have you had a proper look in that drawer?
No, I thought I'd come down here first and start shouting the odds. I'm sorry.
Oh, and we're all feeling a bit that way this morning, love. Well, have you got another tie?
I've got one, but it's not right for a funeral.
Well, not everyone wears black nowadays, love. I mean, some folk reckon their funeral should be more of a celebration.
Yeah, I know, but this is a Homer Simpson tie. He's eating a radioactive donut.
I'll have a proper look for it in a sec. Just...
I'll get that.
So, I think you're right. Today should be a celebration. That's what Jack would have wanted. Just don't know if I'm going to be able to...
Hey, we got through Vera's funeral. We can get through this.
Oh, Tyrone, love. I thought these tissues might be handy in your pocket in case, you know, you get a bit careless at the buffet later.
Cheers, Rita.
Is there anything we can do to help?
No, I think we're all right.
Right, sit down, ladies. I'll get you a brew.
Thanks, love.
Can you hold your nose?
Yeah, okay, I think.
Today of all days, you must be thinking about what Jack said.
I'm thinking about Tyrone. He needs me. That's all that matters.
Hey, you, careful with that polish. I wouldn't want a mouthful of cherry blossom in my next damn butty. You all right, Kev?
Yeah, yeah. Just thinking of Ty. It's not going to be easy for him today, is it?
No. But at least he's got his family to focus on. The future. That'll pull him through. It did me. It's a bit chilly to be standing around here, love.
Yeah, I know, but
It's where I always imagine him. When I first came here, we'd sit out here for hours and he'd be fussing around his pigeons, telling us his stories. This was his place. It was our place.
And it always will be.
Will it? Just talking about him since he... I've thought of loads of stuff that I've forgotten. I just want to write it all down before it goes, but writing's not my thing.
No, but you'll always have your memories. Oh, the details may grow sketchy, but never the meaning and never your feelings. They're written down in indelible ink, in here and in there.
But not here, though, Rita. This is a list. This is not how I feel.
Rip it up, then.
Well, I've got to have something to say.
You have. I've told you. It's all written down where it matters.
The cars are here.
I could have sworn I put them down there.
Stop worrying. You've got your back door key now. Come on, I'm starving. He's not in there. He's with Vera.
Yeah. There's something I want to ask you.
What? Are you ready, love?
It's all right. Now's not the time.
Resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. We have come here today to remember before God our brother Jack, to give thanks for his life, to commend him to God, our merciful Redeemer and Judge, to commit his body to be cremated, and to comfort us in our grief. Please be seated.
Thank you for coming. Jack was born in 1936, and he married his wife, Vera, in 1957. They stayed together for 50 years, celebrating their... Look, you all knew Jack. He loved a pint, he loved a bet, he loved his pigeons, but most of all, he loved Vera. Not that he'd ever admit it. They met at a fair, and he used to say, if he'd have knocked over one more coconut, he'd have come home with a goldfish instead. When he knew he was dying,
The one thing he clung to was the thought that they'd be together again. And they are, I know it. I told my baby last night he's the luckiest kid alive to have guardian angels like them. He's got friends in high places, all right. There's not a lot I can say about Jack that most of yous don't already know, so I'll tell you what Jack was to me. I picked that song you heard coming in, Father and Son, and you might think that's weird because you won't find his name on my birth certificate or his blood in my veins. That's why I've not got his good looks. But none of that makes a dad. I reckon it's someone who'll make you feel loved, share your happiness, feel your blows, take them for you if they can. Someone you can turn to when there's nowhere else left to go, no matter how big a boss, how big a mess you've made of things. And they might not tell you what you want to hear, but they tell you what you need to. Because they'll always, always want what's best for you. Even more than you want it yourself. Even if you don't know it at the time. They'll make you laugh. Really, laugh. Cry maybe if you've let them down. But so long as they live, there'll always be a place that you can call home. Even though I was 16 when we met, Jack came to mean all that to me. And that's why I'm proud to call him a father. And that's why I'm going to miss him so much.
Thank you, Tyrone. We've entrusted our brother Jack to God's mercy, and we now commit his body to be cremated. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. Sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform our frail bodies that they may be conformed to his glorious body, who died, was buried, and rose again for us. To him be glory forever. Amen.
Don't worry, Betty, your knight in shining Armani is here.
Oh, was it a nice service?
Oh. Do you know what? They did Jack proud.
Oh, how lovely. Is this all right for you, my love?
Oh, that's brilliant. Thank you, Betty.
I knew we wanted to do right by him, you know.
Yeah, well, he worked here long enough.
When you say worked, he spent hours, you know, hiding down in the cellar. There's mole spent less time underground than Jack, you know.
Buffy's open, everyone, so fill your boots. Jack would be cursing if there was anything left over.
Oh, I shouldn't worry about that. In half hour, all that will be left of this lot is cocktail sticks and indigestion. Go on, Betty, you take the waiter.
Are you sure?
Yeah,
of course.
Right,
that was lovely, what you said today.
Oh, cheers. Made a bit of a prat on myself, though.
Did it? That's what funerals are for, isn't it?
What's done is done. Can't keep beating yourself up or being mistakes. Hey, if I did that, I'd be black and blue, wouldn't I, love?
I would love you. Now, listen, Dad, she's right. You know, you've got to look forward.
Mm-hmm. Look forward to what? I mean, if I could turn the clock back and
understand...
Then you
win the lottery every week, but that ain't going to happen.
Well, that's the point, isn't it? I mean, I won the lottery. The night I met Elizabeth this Muller. And what did I do then? I blew it. And as a matter of fact, where is she now? I'll tell you what, son, she's avoiding me, so she is.
No. Oh, that's silly, Dad. No, she's had this time booked off for ages.
Ah, well, whatever you say, son.
Thank you.
What for?
Supporting Tyrone.
He was a mate.
Yeah, I know, but it just reminded me of the man that I used to know.
Molly.
It's okay. Just, it reminded me how hard it's been for you as well. You and Ty being so close and all.
Yeah, well, it's all in the past.
Yeah.
I'm not a speechmaker, and I certainly couldn't top Ty's words. Look, we're all going to miss Jack. Not just his friendship and his filthy jokes. We're going to miss his wisdom. There's a lot of us here benefited from that. We're still benefiting now. Yeah, you ducked and you dived. But you always knew what was right and what was wrong. I wish I could sit that quick sometimes. Look, you made Tyrone the man he is today. The sort of bloke I'd trust with my life. And that's why I'm just sorry. I'm sorry you had to go. To Jack.
To Jack.
To Jack.
To Jack.
No one has said I needed to talk to you.
Yeah.
I can't wait any longer. You've been brilliant today. I'd have never got through this without you.
Don't be down.
No, I'm serious. I know we've had our ups and downs, but we've come out stronger. I love you so much more, you and the baby. I know I'm being greedy, but nothing would make me happier than for us to have another kid.
Oh, you know what we talked about yesterday?
We talked about a lot of things yesterday, but it was a lovely service, wasn't it?
Yeah, I know, yeah, but listen, I've been
thinking... I loved everything about it. The church, the flowers, the eulogy. I even thought that coffin was beautiful.
Yeah, but what
I went to my auntie's funeral a few years back. She got cremated in a wicker coffin. I mean, it was lovely, but you wouldn't.
About having another baby?
It was my Auntie Helen. Do you remember my Auntie Helen? Joan's sister.
Look, please, can we just...
What?
What I said yesterday?
What did you say?
About trying for another baby.
I don't know that I'm ready, okay?
Well, just think. A little brother or sister for our Jack. A bit of our own nuclear family.
I don't know. I'm knackered with the one I've got.
Yeah, but if we're going to have two, we may as well get him out of the way.
Oh, who said romance was dead? Give him here, he needs a feed. Come on.
We'll be going checking out a new church today.
Oh?
Why?
Yeah, like lunchtime. This one's a bit more broad-minded than the last one.
How do you mean?
Why, all of a sudden, are you so interested? You're not usually bothered when we talk about church and that.
Well, I must have got out of bed the right side today.
Well, if you must know, we're going to find a church that will accept us for who we are.
Two very nice, well-brought-up young women.
No, Mum. A couple.
Well, I hope it goes okay, because, I mean, you know.
What?
Well, it don't matter what church you go to, does it? It's still the same religion, isn't it?
No, because all churches are different, Mum. They all interpret the Bible in different ways.
Yeah, and some of them have caught on to the modern world.
Right, well, I hope it goes okay. Yeah, see you later.
See you later.
Have a good gay day.
Bye, Mum.
Bye.
Ooh.
What are you oohing at?
I don't know. Just woken up in a really good mood. Which is wrong, because when you've been to a funeral, you should feel all depressed, shouldn't you?
Well, you've had a tough year.
I know, I'm going to Jack's send-off yesterday. It really made me think.
About what?
Well, last Christmas, I don't think I was going to be stood here today.
Well, you are.
I don't know, I just feel dead lucky.
No, I'm the lucky one, finding you, snaring you.
Oh, am I in your trap?
Oh, big time.
Well, then might we be released so we could go out for something to eat tonight, just you and me?
Where?
Don't know, I'll... I'm thinking I'll text you.
Oh, well, have a happy ending.
A very happy ending.
Well, count me in.
If we do want another one, I just think it's best we get it out of the way rather than waiting.
If?
Well, don't you?
Well, the more you pressurise me, the less likely I am to be up for it.
So that it's not something you want?
Well, right now what I want is to go back to bed and sleep for a million years, but it's not possible, is it? I'll just make sure the house is tidy until Jack wakes up for his next feed. Will you go to work? I'll see you later.
Suppose. Thought you did a wicked job yesterday, mate. Everything about it was... I don't know. Right?
Oh, cheers, yeah. Did my best.
Well, it was good, mate.
Ta. I just wish I was as successful with Molly.
In what way?
We've always talked about having a big family, right? But every time I mention trying for another baby, she's just like...
Oh, women. Of a different breed. It's in the DNA to keep changing the mind.
Well, tell me about it.
Listen, mate. She'll be all babied out in a minute. She won't know whether she's up or down. The thought of going through it all again must be a bit scary.
You sound just like her.
Hi, love.
Hey, Mum, babe. How's work?
Same old, same old. Oh, I wish I did an interesting job where each day was different from the day before, but...
Oh, Mum. It's a shame you're too old for promotion work. It's so cool and stuff. Do you want to sit down?
No, I'm going to go and jump in the bath.
I'll be sure to put some water in it first.
I'm going on a romantic trip tonight.
Mum? With your dad.
Oh, right, okay.
I'm putting the romance back in our marriage.
Aw, that's lush, Mum. Where are you going?
The joinery, Nick and Leanne's new place.
Mum, like, isn't that a bit too young for you? I tell you what, babe, why don't I give you a makeover?
You don't look that bad, do I?
Long-term relationships do not work unless you ring the changes.
Who told you that?
Baby Spice this morning. She's amazing.
Well, you could do my makeup. That'd be nice.
Mum, serious, you are going to look amazing.
Oh, Sophie, Sean, I'm glad I've seen you.
All right.
I appreciate, I might have seemed rather short with you the other day. I don't feel wonderful about dismissing you like that.
I'm used to it. Went to see a new church today. Yeah, one that wants us, even if we might be different.
Well, I've always had a rather literal view of the scriptures, I'm afraid.
Look, Emily, I'm a good person. Okay, I try to be a good person.
I know that.
I didn't make me gay. God made me gay.
Yeah, and if God made us gay, then why should we be punished for that?
But the Bible says...
Don't eat shellfish. Have you ever ate prawns? Exactly, so don't try and tell me how to live my life.
I'm not. I would never do that. I just struggle. I'm being honest. I do love you, Sophie, and I'll try my best to be here for you.
Thank you. Come on, Cher.
Molly, come over here. Okay, come out here, mate, and back us up.
I'm just trying to get him off to sleep. What is it? What do you want?
Come on, Mo.
All right.
Kev, don't you think it'd be a good idea if we had another baby?
Hey, don't drag me into all this.
Oh, come on, you've got to. Why can't we have two?
Tyrone, that's so immature.
No, what I'm saying
is... No, you're
it?
Not saying anything. You sound like a four-year-old. And stop banging on like I'm some sort of harridan who's put my foot down and said no.
Is he saying yeah?
I don't know. Now doesn't feel like the right time, okay? But I'm not ruling it out.
Nice one. Hey, just think of all the fun we're going to have trying.
Yeah, aren't I the lucky one?
Well, there's no need to be like that.
Yeah, well, snap! You've talked about nothing else.
Pardon me for trying to plan the future.
You just want more sex.
What? Look, can we talk about this later?
No! Come on, you drag me over here. You've got Kevin involved.
I'm out of here before I say something I regret.
Come on.
He's talked about now else. He's obsessed.
And you probably had babies up to here.
Handsome.
Hey, come on. You know it's going to be all right.
Is it?
You know it is. Look, you should only do what you want to do.
She said, love you, boy, I love you so. She said, love you, baby, oh, oh, oh.
I hope you're doing a good job, Rosie.
Oh, totes.
I don't want to look like Jordan. Can I have a look in the mirror?
Hey, babe.
Hi.
Hi. How amazing does Mum look?
Oh, I do look amazing. Thanks, Rosie. Hey, how was the church, girls?
Yeah, it was all right, wasn't it?
Yeah, they were dead nice.
Did they get the whole lesbo vibe?
Rosie.
Well, they referred to Sophie as my partner, so... But it was dead nice. It was a lot older, though, you know, like 40-odd or something.
Yeah, well, this decrepit old 40-something is off out painting the town red tonight. You're not over the hill, you know, just because you're a child of the 60s. Oh, you're full of free love, Mum, and joss sticks. Ah, you know, I love joss sticks, but free love might be worth a go. You all right, Soph?
Yeah. I've just seen Emily.
What did she say?
Oh, she loves us.
Oh, well, that's good, isn't it?
Hi. I'm, sorry about earlier.
You're all right.
Do you mind if I join you?
Ah, oh, got to go in a bit. Going out with Sally.
Okay.
So, what are you going to do?
About Tyrone? Well, on one level, it'll solve a lot of problems. but at the end of the day, I could have a football team in Tyrone, but Jack will always be yours. Before Jack died, he told me not to string Tyrone along. Not if I didn't love him. It's not right.
And what is right? There's that many wrongs here. I'm losing track of what's right.
This feels right.
What?
Us. Me and you. What's right is that Jack's real parents are together bringing him up.
I love Sally.
I'm just being honest with you, Kevin. I'm sick of all these lies. I've been fighting it for too long, but it's true.
Don't.
You were so nice to me today.
We're mates.
I'm not over you.
Please.
All these feelings, they're still there.
Molly.
I'm still in love with you.
Do you really like it, Mummy, just saying it?
I think it looks fabulous. Made a rod for your own back, though, because I'm going to be asking you again.
Well, I might start charging then.
All I need now is my husband. Where on earth has he got to?
I thought I didn't care, but I've just been kidding myself. When I think about what we've been through, what we've got, what we could have, the truth is, I can't get you out of my head. Say something.
There's nothing to say.
You were in love with me once.
Not anymore.
Feelings like that don't just go away. It's Ali. You only went back with her because she was ill. She doesn't need you anymore.
I fell back in love with her.
You're just saying that because you feel guilty.
It's the truth.
We've got a child. He needs his parents.
He said all along he was sticking with Tyrone.
I've told you. I've changed my mind.
Yeah, well, change it back.
I can't live with these lies. Once he said he wanted another child, it's not his child I want.
Oh, I can't handle any more of this.
Because you know I'm right.
I'm looking for Kevin.
All right, I've not seen him since I left the garage.
Supposed to be going out for dinner tonight.
Oh, I've just finished changing Jack.
Oh, he looks very happy with that.
Well, he wasn't 10 minutes ago. Believe me, he was screaming the arms down.
No problem with the lungs at that age, have they?
Oh. Hi, Sal.
Hi.
Nice.
Oh, I'm just about to steal your husband off you. I'm joking, you dope. You haven't seen Kevin, have you?
No.
I can't think where he's got to.
Have you tried the garage?
Yeah, I went there first.
Anyway, never mind, Kev. Where have you been?
To the chemist.
Look, I'll leave you to it.
Have you tried the pub?
Yeah, I was going to go there next.
All right, bye, Sal.
See ya.
Bye.
Right, come on, I'll take him.
No, he's okay.
I'll take him. Hiya.
You're here. Hey, I've been looking for you all over.
Why? What's up?
We're going out for dinner in case you've forgotten. God, it was good job I booked a table, honestly.
I'm sorry, love. It's just been one of them days.
Yeah, well, get your skates on, because we've got a table booked in half an hour. Where have you been, anyway?
The pub.
No, you weren't. Not when I went in.
Oh, we must have just missed each other.
What?
You look amazing.
Mm, thank you.
Yeah, thanks to my handiwork.
Yeah, Rosie did it.
Yeah, she always looks beautiful on a normal day to me.
Yeah. She does.
Come on, hurry up and go and get changed.
Look, I'm sorry I went on at you in front of Kev.
Yeah, it's okay.
No, I was out of order.
I said it's okay.
You don't sound okay. You've been weird ever since you got back. Look, you'd say if there was something wrong, wouldn't you?
The thing is, Ty.
Oh, pal! Oh, Daisy, we've been sick. Never mind. Just a bit of practice in it, eh? For an 18 years time when you're out on the lash. Yeah. But you're having back our rinse out. There we go.
Come on.
What was you going to say? Because if it's about having another baby, right?
Ty, can we not talk about that?
Fine.
I'll have the mixed Lancashire tapas, please. Good choice.
I'll have the same, please, and a bottle of 21.
Not a problem.
Why would it be a problem?
What?
Well, you come in here wanting to spend money and they say it's not a problem, like sometimes it is.
Shut up, Kevin. We've not been out for a meal for ages. And we're here to celebrate life.
Not a problem. Oh, we should do this more often.
Oh, there's a breakdown call to bring us back to Earth. Is it?
Yeah, they can go and whistle.
Oh, have you enjoyed it?
Well, just couldn't help myself.
I'm going to have a makeover more often.
There's nothing to do with a makeover. Because I love you.
I love you. You've been very romantic.
You complaining?
Well, couples don't normally fall in love again until after the children have gone and get their lives back.
Yeah, they'll be gone soon. Maybe we should start planning for it.
How do you mean?
Oh, go and live abroad like Kathleen Clare.
What, in France?
Oh, Spain, you know, when it's cheap and warm and we can eat out on the terrace every night.
This is half a bottle of wine and I'm brandy speaking.
Don't tell me it doesn't grab you.
Oh, not again.
Oh, I'm going to have to go.
I thought you said you were going to ignore it.
I know, but word soon gets around if you're unreliable.
What? How long are you going to be?
Well, it's only a punch around the corner. I'll walk it. Half an hour, maybe.
Well, don't be longer. Unfinished business tonight. Told him I've got a headache.
You've got 5 minutes.
You were always this keen to get rid of me when we used to meet in here.
Just say what you got to.
All right. We were going to run away together once.
So?
So, we could do it again.
What?
That way you'd be a proper father to our son.
You must be joking.
I nearly told Tyrone tonight, but I bottled it.
What about us?
You might not love me now, but that would come in time.
That's not going to happen.
Look at me. Look at me. I want to be with you. It can work.
Look, I'm not leaving, Sally. We're closer now than we've been in years. You leave Tyrone, you'll be on your own.
I just want what's best for our family, which is what we are now, whether you like it or not.
I'll tell you one last time. I love Sally. I feel nothing for you, never will. So forget it.
Okay.
How are you feeling?
Yeah, fine.
You was gone a long time, we're starting to worry.
Oh, I just walked round the block a few times.
Can I get you anything?
No, I'm fine now.
Well, it's past 11. Best get to bed, eh? His master's voice will be waking us up in 6 hours.
Yeah.
Are you sure you're okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm just tired, that's all.
Well, don't be too long. I've tidied up down here, so there's not to do.
All right, I'll be up in a sec.
Oh, she only broke the trout trying.
Are you inferring that I wear too much makeup?
Not inferring, implying. Check your dictionary, sister.
Do you know, I never understood the difference.
Oh, yeah, because it's got to be said. The day I take hair and beauty advice from a lesbian.
It's like flammable and inflammable.
Is the day you what?
Is the day that I start looking like a normal human being. No, it's the day that I die.
Oh, meet Mary Porter.
Oh, we're not worthy enough.
Your dad's come round to Mary, haven't we, love?
What?
You know, how are the bob and the knuckle duster rings?
Oh, ignoring him, still stewing over Friday night.
Why? What happened Friday night?
Oh, he only jibbed his date with Mum so we can go on a breakdown.
Oh, well, we had that coffee.
Dad, there is more important things in life than money. Name one. Except... by the time we got there, the cheeky pigs had driven off.
You can't trust anybody these days.
Earth to Mummy.
Hey.
Come in, Mummy.
What?
Huh? He was rubbing that same spot for 5 minutes then. His poor little bum's going to be red raw. Isn't it, Nutnose, eh? Be like one of them monkeys from Nosley Safari Park.
Not your problem, Ty.
I'm just saying, you know, if he gets whingy and you need a break, you know where I am.
You're saying I can't cope?
No. But a little baby is a lot of work.
But you want another one all the same.
Okay, truce.
Listen, we're having the afternoon off, I've decided.
Oh, is that the Royal We?
Team Dobbs on a mission.
Where are we going, Knowsley Safari Park? Because I was going to say, are you busy at dinner time?
I am now, yeah.
What, scattering the ashes? Today?
It's got to be done sometime.
Are you sure you're feeling up to it?
As long as I've got used to it with me. Anyway, I promised him. Well, he promised her and then I promised him.
Look, spit it out, Si.
I just want a couple of hours off so I can scatter Jack and Vera's ashes in Blackpool.
Oh, take the rest of the day off, mate.
Are you sure? Because I said I'd pick up Connie as well if this time.
You go and pick Connie up. I'll phone Molly. Let her know you're on your way.
Cheers, mate. I'll make up the time.
Told him. That's obvious.
Not today. It's Jack and Vera's day. I'm not going to spoil that.
What, tomorrow?
I'll choose my moment.
And destroy his life.
Let's not do this again.
Hi.
I thought you rang because you had something to say.
Oh, where is he? Let me see. Oh, please, can I pick him up?
He's just got him asleep. Shush.
Probably's going to take him for a walk. Just round the back.
Yeah.
All right, thank you. My dad will make you a cup of coffee if you're lucky.
New Zealand.
Well, chunk that.
Ah, oh, because this recipe calls for New Zealand.
Oh, go on, live a little.
Another winning combination. Claire and Ashley, roast lamb and mint sauce.
Herbie lamb cobbler, actually. An old classic with a contemporary twist.
A bit like yourself, Sal, eh?
Are you sure he's good for business?
Yeah, I tell you, I'd have no business only for this lad. Put me back on straight and narrow, he has. During darker days.
How are you and Claire?
I'm picking up.
Give him my regards.
He thinks he's been a bit of a bore lately.
Well, don't all rust in, ain't it?
Well, pain can do that to a person. I'll have a pound of Welsh, then.
Hey, people don't mind a sad bore. Makes them count their blessings. There's no bore like a smug bore. I've got a fit wife and $1 million turnover type of thing. Sends us reaching for the bread knife.
Yeah, well, I think I'm safe on that score. Unless you want to swap the chump for some fella.
Hey, he's still got his mojo, bro.
I'm not asking you to choose one child over the other two.
That's what it sounded like. In fact, it sounded more of a threat than an ask.
Blended families, the world is full of them. Yeah, it's painful when any marriage splits up, but time is a great healer. I love your girls.
You can't love my girls.
Like them, then. Enjoy their company. Nothing would make me happier than to have them in our lives, in Jack's life especially.
Yeah, and you think they'd ever forgive me?
You'd be amazed what people come to terms with. You told me to get rid of our baby before he was born, remember?
Yeah, you'd still set me back.
We could make it work. But only if you want to. But then I've said all this.
And I've said it's never going to happen.
So why did you ring?
Because Tyrone asked me.
Because if you want to change your mind, and I believe deep down you do, you best do it quick. I won't wait around forever.
Don't tell me you've left the baby on the bus.
No. Sophie's taking him for a walk. We'll catch her on Tile Street.
Nice to see you, Connor. Don't be a stranger.
What, with these two around? Won't be allowed, love.
I mean it. Time's one thing you haven't got.
Follow that pram.
Yeah. Not sitting in A&E for 5 hours waiting for you to get your fingers sewn back on.
Ah, you're a dab hand of a needle and cut and you could just do it.
Come Rosie, she's not even done a tap.
Hello, Nails.
Hi, love. Hey, we're doing the Herbie Lamb Cobbler for tea.
Right.
Gonna give Delia a run for her money, aren't we, girls?
Yeah. Hey, Jace.
Yeah. Oh, hey. Rosie, tell them what we're having for tea. Bet his mother doesn't do anything more complicated than opening a tin of beans.
Mum, like he's supposed. Anyway, we're off out.
Okay, stick mine in the oven. I'll have it later.
Hold on a minute, Kev. Why don't you eat with the rest of us?
Just back off and leave me be.
What's the matter?
Nothing.
Kevin, if something's bugging you, you'll feel much better if you talk about it.
Why do women have to analyse everything to death? Just give me some peace.
I need to think that's all there is in the end. Living, breathing, human beings. Just turn to dust.
I know.
That's what'll happen to us, all that dust.
Stop being so morbid, eh?
No, I'm just saying. You know, it's so important to really live your life. Every precious minute of it.
Yeah.
today made me realise how lucky I am. I've got everything I want. You, the baby. As far as I'm concerned, my life's perfect. Mom, I'm sorry.
Yeah, no, it's okay, I'm fine. I just, it's been a bit of a day, that's all.
Hey, how's Blackpool?
Yeah, it was good.
Where did you scatter the ashes?
Off the end of the North Pier.
Yeah, we took the tram as far as we could up, and as we was about to do it, the sun came out.
Oh, that's Jack and Vera resting in peace in their favourite part of the world, eh?
Peaceful, them two, they can bicker for England.
Oh, I couldn't have a word.
Yeah, go for it.
I've got any idea what's up with Kevin, have you?
Well, it seems fine to me, why'd you ask?
Oh, I don't know, he just seems a bit touchy now, he's distracted or something.
Well, he's not set out.
Oh, I'm sure I'll drag it out of him in the end, I always do.
Told you. Please don't start.
Sally said you were stressed.
Is it any wonder?
I've been keeping this to myself for months, and I am telling you, it's killing me.
Look, keep your voice down.
All this pretending, that is the cruelest thing. Pretending to Tyrone that we've got any sort of future together.
Keep calm.
Hey, I'm parched. What's taking so long?
The bus is gone. Liz has got to change the barrel.
Hey, what's the matter?
Nothing. I'm fine. It's just scattering the ashes, like you say. It makes you think.
Oh, come here. Have you got any cab?
No.
Pam?
Look, I've said everything I want to say to you. Fat lot of good it's done me.
Look, do you think you want to be stood here talking to you either?
Well, I presume you're not wanting to invite me to Christmas dinner.
Molly wants us to get back together. And before you ask, that's the last thing I want.
Oh, well, we'd best do something about it then, if it's not what you want.
I'm asking for your help, not for my sake.
You know, you really are the most selfish man I have ever met. You didn't give a toss about your wife and family when you took advantage of a vulnerable, silly girl. Led her on, promised her the earth, and dropped her like a flipping stone.
My wife got cancer. And as for the baby, no one knows how much I want that to be Tyrone's, for everybody's sake.
Baby Jack is Tyrone's. You just look at that birth certificate. But you couldn't leave it alone, could you?
You're going to talk to her or not?
Of course I am. If only to tell her to stop wasting her time on a disgusting, selfish waste of skin like you.
Right heartbreaker, this one.
Yeah.
Just like his mother.
Is that supposed to be funny?
Well, there's not funny in any of this.
Oh, you want to try being in my shoes?
Yeah, and I wish you could be in mine. So you could stand back and look at everything. You'd soon be saying, what's she doing? A beautiful baby. Husband who adores her. Lots of women had killed for that.
Not just a social call, then.
Kevin's just stopped me in the street. Asked me to get you to back off.
And since when have you done what he says?
Since he's finally said something sensible. Molly, love, I don't know what's going on in that head of yours.
What's going on in my head is knowing that I want to be with Kevin and our baby. And I also know that no matter what he says, it's what he wants to. So if you can't get your head around that, then do not bother wasting your breath.
Got your drink in.
Thank you. Didn't think we were still talking.
Is that what you want?
Of course it isn't.
That's what's going to happen, love. Falling out. And not just with me. Everybody. Your dad, your friends.
Not with you.
Anyone who don't buy into this fantasy of yours. And you're going to run off with Kevin.
You haven't seen the way he looks at Jack. The way he looks at me.
No. But I have seen the way he looks at Sally. You know, me and your gran never talked. Oh, we fell out over a bloke. She tried to warn me off him. Well, I wouldn't listen. Of course, I knew better. Even years after, we're still both too stubborn to give in. Then it was too late.
Okay. Even if Kevin is as bad as you think, it doesn't make any difference to the way I feel about Tyrone.
Exactly, love. Hey, you said you went back to Tyrone because you loved him. Only a short time ago, you were the happiest bride in Manchester. Happiest couple before Kevin turned your head. Oh, yeah. Not the first woman to have an affair. Plenty do just what you've done.
and then they come to the senses.
But, Jack...
Oh, do you really think that little baby could wish for a better father than Tyrone?
Oh, my love.
I know things are hard for you right now. You'll give it a go with Ty. And 6 months down the line, you'll be so glad you did.
What about his idea for another baby?
If he hadn't have suggested it, I would have. A proper family. Something I'd have given my eye teeth for. Look, you fell in love with Tyrone once, and I bet when you start trying for that baby, it'll happen all over again. Come in.
So, have you, No, I'm not even going to say out.
Okay. Have a good day, then.
Have you thought any more about what we said?
What we said?
Well, what I said. Oh, just forget it.
You mean about us having another baby?
You don't have to answer. I'm going to work.
Wait. I have thought about it, actually.
And what? You still think no?
No. I think... maybe you might be right.
What, that we should?
Well, like you say, we'd be a proper little family then, wouldn't we?
Oh, babe, that is just fantastic.
Well, it might take a while, though.
It's only me.
Don't go broadcasting it.
No, I won't.
Hiya.
Hi, Sal.
Hiya, Sal.
Yeah, I'm going to get to work, but... Oh, look at Jack, eh?
To go.
Well, it wasn't for most of the night.
It's not his fault, though, is it?
Anyway, I was just going to say, I've got today off. I was going to ask if you fancy coming shopping.
Oh, yeah, that'll do you good.
Do you mind? I can lead my own life, thank you.
You was the one complaining about being stuck in the house by yourself all day.
If you're going to go to work, will you go?
Make her go with you.
Oh, I don't want to force her.
Right, I'll say bye to Jack.
Anyway, I don't mean setting off right now. I thought we could go later on this morning.
Right, see you later.
Bye.
Bye.
Can't get rid of him sometimes.
Hey, and Rosie said she'll come as well, so I thought we could have a look round the shops and then we could go for lunch somewhere.
Go easy on that credit card, you.
Yeah, well, we're only going to be looking.
Yeah, well, unless we see something we like. You haven't seen Rosie, have you?
She's on my other than Jason for some money, because I won't give it on her.
Well, I've got plenty for both of us. Come on, let's go and find her and get going. See you later.
See ya.
I think he found shopping boring. He's exhausted.
Of course he has. He's a man. All men find it boring. So, did you buy me out?
No, we just weren't really in the right shops.
Yeah, it doesn't matter, I was only joking.
Anyway, listen, Sally and Rosie have gone for a drink in that joinery place and they want me to go with them.
So go.
What, are you sure? I don't think it's very fair, but...
Of course it's fair. Look, have you got enough money?
Yeah, of course I have. And it won't be long, it'll be like an hour tops.
Be as long as you like. But listen, what you said before about us having another baby.
Well, you said it first.
I just think it's going to be, like, perfect. Thank you.
All right. See ya.
Bye.
I don't want a baby till I'm at least 31. And then my figure will be going anyway, so it won't really matter.
Well, things don't always go to plan. In fact, I don't know anything that does in this life.
Did you actually want a baby? Or was it like an accident?
You can't ask people that question.
Well, what? I mean, she does have to answer.
Right, well, it wasn't planned exactly, but now I've had him, I feel like he was.
Yeah, you couldn't wish for a better father.
Tyrone's been terrific.
I don't know what Jason would be like with the baby.
Oh, let's hope we don't find out. Honestly, do you know what? I don't know what you see in that lad.
He's not a lad.
Well, he's got the mentality of one. After everything we've given, you know, private education and...
Oh, here we go,
she
Mother.
Throws herself at Jason Grimshaw. Honestly, even his name's horrible. Do you really want to be called Grimshaw?
Oh, yes, Mother, because Webster's, like, really upper class, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, compared to Grimshaw. Sorts of plans for you and Sophie. I was going to turn you both into lovely young ladies.
What, are you trying to say that I'm not?
Of course you're not.
Well, do you want to be?
Well, I am a lot better than some. I don't do drugs.
No, all I'm saying is you don't know how your kids are going to turn out, do you?
Well, like Sophie seeing her prayers every night.
And what about Jack? What's Jack?
I'm not bothered as long as he's happy. Right, I'm going to get another round, but this has got to be my last.
You mind a couple of visitors?
Aye, no, come in.
Yeah, Mo's still out with your Sal and Rosie, having a drink at that new bar, so... Me and him had a chat, decided the men should get together and all.
Oh, and look at what he's got hiding in his nappy bag. Da-da! You wouldn't think he's old enough to buy them, would you? But he says they never ask his age. I'm not disturbing you, am I?
No, it's good to see you.
All right, well, I just thought you'd be on your own, same as me.
Yeah.
There you go then, pal. Here's to the men.
The men.
One, I promise, because I don't know about you, but I need to get home sometime.
Yeah, okay, but I'll just, wash a ring tie. You're terrible, you, Mum. You're worse than me.
Yeah, well, I've had loads of practice.
Oh, can you tell me?
Yeah, go on then.
I'm still here, but I'll be home after I finish this drink, okay?
Yeah, that's okay. You take as long as you like.
Is that Jack I can hear?
Yeah, but he's alright. We're seeing to him. It's not a problem. Nothing's going on. Just brought him round to Kev's, that's all. We're having a party of our own here.
Well, don't go getting him all excited because we'll be up with him all night.
He's fine. Kev's got him.
Has he?
Yeah.
You just enjoy yourself and don't worry about us. We best be getting back. She heard him crying, so she'll be worrying.
Yeah, of course. Oh, but first, let me give you something. We have a Christmas present for him.
Whoa, what? Do you think we've got no money?
I think you're loaded. I know what you take home every week. Here, just want him to have something from me. There you go.
Well, that's too much, Kev.
What, now you're saying I can't afford it?
No, I'm just saying, he's a baby. There's not much you can get him at that age.
Well, put it in a bank account for him until he's older or something. I don't know. I just want him to have something from me, that's all.
OK, cheers. Hey, listen, I'm not supposed to be telling anyone, but me and Moll are going to be trying for another.
Another?
Baby, yeah. So you never know. Might be asking you to be a godfather again soon. And it'll cost you double next Christmas. See you tomorrow.
Yeah, see you, mate.
Oh, I love him. He was laughing away up there.
He's supposed to be sleeping.
He was. At first.
You can't just come home on your break and wake him up.
Yeah, no, I just love that big smile when he sees his daddy looking at him.
Why can't your husband do slopes off to the pub every chance he gets, eh?
Oh, there's plenty of time for that. Give it 30 years, we'll be Jack and Vera down to a tea. Have you got any ideas what we can do with that 100 quid Tom and Sal gave him for Grimbo?
Well, it's way too much if you ask me.
Well, they love the little mite, don't they? How lucky is he to have godparents like that?
Yeah, dead lucky.
Ty, ever seen Kevin? Have you? I was hoping you could buy me some dinner.
No, he's on a call out.
Oh, what a shame. I want a good moan and a long drink after the morning we've had.
Carla cracking the whip, eh?
She's like a demented lion tamer. What I wouldn't give to tell her where to stuff a job. You know, but with it being Christmas and everything.
Yeah, we want to make this year's a good one, too. Oh, by the way, thanks so much to you and Kev for that money you gave us for baby Jack.
Oh, right, yeah, no, it's a pleasure. Molly could buy a nice little outfit for him with it.
For 100 quid, we'll buy him a baby tuxedo. Oh, I'm going to have to get that. I'll see you later.
Jack, you've already said you don't want anything to do with us.
It was just a Christmas present.
You've made your position quite clear. You don't want us and we don't want your guilt money. Hiya, Sal.
Hi, Molly. Where's that gorgeous baby of yours?
Oh, he's Dewey the Teeth.
Oh, get him started early, that's what I say.
Thank you so much for that money for Jack.
Well, it's a pleasure. He is our godson, after all.
It's way too much, but I'll let you off. See you later.
See ya. 100 quid.
What? Ty caught me in a soppy mood.
Yeah, well, I was the one who looked soppy when Tyrone thanked me this morning. I had to pretend I knew all about it.
Well, you was that bladdered when you come in last night. Even if I told you, you wouldn't remember.
I've got two daughters of our own. You were quick enough to say no to Rosie when she asked you for some money. You come in.